And we look forward to the role he will again play as a colleague, leader, client advisor, and advocate. Holder said returning to the firm was like coming home.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports New York City has agreed to pay more than $330,000 to six Occupy Wall Street protesters who were doused with pepper spray without cause, an incident that helped galvanize the movement during its early days. Lawyer Mark Taylor, who represented three of the protesters, said on Monday that the settlements for each of the six individuals ranged from $52,500 to $60,000. Taylor said, "We think it's good compensation for the injuries that occurred to our clients. They are settlements we think reflects the city's realization that they were very much liable." The deals, which resolved several civil lawsuits filed in Manhattan federal court, come nearly 4 years after Occupy protests swept the country as activists called for greater income equality. The city did not admit wrongdoing as part of the agreements. The incident, captured on video, occurred on September 24, 2011, just a few days after Occupy protesters set up camp in a park in New York's financial district. The video shows Deputy Inspector Anthony Bologna using pepper spray on several protesters during a march in downtown Manhattan. The New York City Police Department docked Bologna 10 vacation days for violating the departmental policy. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A fully leveled up video game character marvels at how far he's come, and the milk rushing through a jug handle is having the time of its life. This is The Onion Week in Review. This week, top executives from the U.S. financial sector announced they're about ready to ruin the world again. Representatives from all major banking and investment institutions said that more than enough time has passed since they last caused a major global economic meltdown, and confirmed they're pretty much fully prepared to bring about a brand new worldwide financial crisis.
We feel like we've given people enough time to get comfortable again. Consumer spending has increased. Housing market has rebounded. So yeah, we're all set to go ahead and ruin the global economy again.
And in other news, the perfect gift for a local man is unfortunately a gift certificate to Lowe's Cinemas. Mall shoppers look on in awe as a helpless 15-year-old girl is viciously torn apart by a pack of her peers. And a drunk pilot decides to pull over onto a cloud until he sobers up. You will now hear three gong strikes and a recitation of the great chant before being ushered to the hallowed garden. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Again, 855-450, and then the word free. That's 3733. You can call us and talk about whatever's on your mind. We actually also have Skype, so you can use that. Our username is lrn.fm. You'd have to send us a user request on Skype, but you know, we approve it, and then you can call anytime you want. It maybe takes tops 10 minutes for us to approve it, so we're not talking about a long process here. And your audio is going to sound a lot better. So that's username lrn.fm on Skype. It's King Mark the First here.
And Conan the Barbarian.
That's right. You have that name legit, too, right?
Oh, it's legit.
Yeah.
My dad was a big fan, and I ended up with it. By the way, I was named before the movie.
Well, I mean,
couple of years before the movie.
So, like off the Frank Frazetta paintings, or
There was a definite. We talked about this a little while ago. There was a revival, a Conan revival,
yes,
here in the U.S., and it was Frank Frazetta who brought that during the late '60s, '70s, and it really took off. And people found out who Conan was, and there you go. I got it.
There's a really sad story that we have of an individual who thought he had superhuman strength too.
Uh oh. Yeah, well, sadly, it was one of our neighbors right up into the east, Maine, who they got a little lax on their fireworks laws in 2012, I believe, And we have very lax laws here. I don't even know if there are laws at all here in New Hampshire.
There are some laws. I don't believe you can have sort of the explosive type of fireworks here in New Hampshire.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I don't think there are bottle rockets. But we do have pretty lax laws as far as different types of fireworks.
Right. You know? We know that the Massachusetts folk come up to actually buy fireworks and alcohol in the whole nine, and the same thing with Vermont.
Yeah, the cops will lay wait at the border trying to catch them, bringing back their explosives and cigarettes and alcohol. No doubt about it. But you just can't stop all those people because you don't know where they went. You don't know what they did.
Well, and hopefully this doesn't backfire on us because the mother of this individual, this superhero, is already in the works trying to make sure that it doesn't happen again, or that at least people are educated. So let's start with the story. Instead of going right to the punch, this is the Washington Post, entitled "Maine Man Didn't Mean to Launch Fireworks from His Head That Killed Him."
Yeah.
So
what kind of firework was it?
Well, I think it was some kind of a mortar.
Yeah.
They've got the Roman candles, that might be considered a mortar.
What a mortar is, when they sell them as fireworks, is that's this little ball that has this sort of cylinder on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
It has a long wick. You light the wick and drop it into a tube. That tube comes with it. The tube's maybe 2 inches in diameter, and it is about a foot long and then has a little base on it.
So you reuse the mortar, you just add ammunition.
Yep.
So it's like a real mortar.
Yeah, you get 12 what I bought the last time, it was like $50. You get 12 of these shots and you drop them in the tube and the tube's fine generally. I can see why somebody would think that it would be just fine to fire this thing off your head, because I fired it off my porch and didn't seem to have any trouble over it.
Well, maybe it was upside down and it went the opposite direction.
I have no clue. But you don't play around with fireworks because you never know. What if it's a dud and it doesn't shoot and it just explodes?
Right. You don't walk around with a handgun on your head,
right,
hoping that it doesn't go off.
No.
It's just silliness. Those close to Devon Staples, who died when he lit fireworks on his head on the 4th of July, said Monday that the young man probably didn't know what he was doing. They speculated that he lit the mortar accidentally or thought it was a dud.
You should never assume something's a dud, but all right. I suppose you could have gotten close to it or something.
Yeah, I mean, and they said that they saw that it was working. It was working at one time, but we'll get to that. According to local police, Staples, 22, was messing around with friends in...
That's already a mark against him as far as I'm concerned.
Exactly. He hasn't grown up yet. I'm hoping I'm saying this right. Calais, Maine, drinking and setting off fireworks.
Okay, so alcohol, all right. So he's 22 and was drinking.
And with friends.
Uh-huh.
And it's 4th of July.
Yeah, okay. So at this point, I have very little room in my, in my heart to say that this was some kind of... I mean, I'll call it a tragedy. It's certainly a tragedy, but I'm not going to call it some kind of mistake.
This is getting ready to be a train wreck.
Right. When I lit off fireworks on the 4th of July, I had one that didn't go off.
Mm-hmm.
And, I was kind of careful of it for a little while. I just let it sit. But at some point or another, you got to go over there to it, right?
Right, right.
Now, if it would have gone off, now this was just one of those that kind of, the golden shower. I love these.
that's what it's called?
It's called a golden shower. And it shoots out these just, sort of golden fan-shaped sparkly things. And it's, Jack loves them. And they're the kind of fireworks my wife can get behind. So we always buy those. And then, but if this thing would have gone on and been explosive, and as I went to it to get rid of it or something like that, I would call that, a tragic error or mm-hmm. something like that. This sounds like a tragic error in judgment.
Right. I believe that that's where it's going to come down to it.
All right.
So anyways, they're drinking. They're 22.
Uh-huh.
They're with buddies. It's 4th of July. They're setting off fireworks, and he put a mortar on his head and lit it. Mortars are cardboard tubes holding packaged fireworks.
So he put a mortar on his head and lit it.
Mm-hmm. Though it is unclear what type of firework was in the tube, the firework exploded, instantly killing Staples.
Mm.
So I'm almost thinking it must have been upside down in order to instantly kill. I mean, that's...
It could have just exploded. So another thing they do is these mortars is when they go up, like you wouldn't believe. They go, poof! And they're up, and then bam, they're blowing up into those powerful fireworks that you sort of see at displays. Mm-hmm. Generally, these mortars don't have sort of as many, you know, they're not as big and as in the sky, but they'll shoot out 5, 6, 7, 8, I don't know, different colored, you know, things that come out of them. And but they're up in the air. They're up very quickly. I don't know whether this thing just didn't fly up in the air, whether they put a firework that wasn't the right type in there or what it was. But
well, what kind of kick is coming off of these
guys? A good
guys?
One.
All right. So maybe could it have been the kick that knocked him in the head and gave him a concussion or
that's
something?
That's what I assumed when I just sort of heard about the story, that that's what happened. I guess it doesn't surprise me, but none of it surprises me. You're dealing with explosives.
Yeah.
Explosives, young men, alcohol, none of this stuff should go together.
So anyway, Staples' fiance.
So many times when I was a kid, you know, like it would always be my uncles or my dad setting off fireworks, and they'd never let me get anywhere near them.
They gave you the sparklers.
Right, and I wanted so bad to get near those sparklers. The people who are the people least qualified to play with fireworks are the ones that want to play with them the most.
Right.
You know, I mean, the safest bet is to just never touch the things, but you got to live life too, right? And fireworks are pretty awesome. So, I feel this is a tragic mistake in judgment. You know, if you're saying 10 people a year, is that the number you said? 10 people
12,
a year?
12 people a year last year.
Yeah, 12 people last year died from fireworks. Well, how many died from the flu? How many died from cows? I mean, cows kill like 40 people a year.
Yeah, more people died from cows last year than they did from fireworks.
Right.
I think it's like 40 or
between
20 and 40.
Every one of these things is tragic. We're going to hear from this young man's mother here shortly in this story. And I feel for this woman. I mean, this is a terrible, tragic thing to have happen. And every tragedy in and of itself is a tragedy. You know, there's a story of a Florida man who decides I believe F that gator, and then decides to jump in the gator pond and the gator kills him or something like that. That's another story that's out right now.
Was alcohol involved in that one as well?
Yeah. And, you know, all those things. I mean, do I hope for this person's death? No, I don't. But the more risks you take in life, the bigger your chance of not coming out of these risks.
This is correct.
I just saw a video of an Italian man flying through this hole in the rocks that are like 1.7 meters wide. So he's flying through this just hole in a mountain. I don't even know what else to call it. It's a hole in a rock. And he flies through it on one of them paragliding suit things. And he made it. And God bless him.
Wow.
But if he'd have gone smoosh up against the side, you know, I wouldn't be like, let's outlaw this paragliding stuff. I'd be like, well, that was a poor choice on his part. What do you think? 855-450-3733.
P150GA, P150LK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
Have you put off seeing the dentist because you can't afford to go? Are big dental bills taking a big toll on your wallet? Would you like to have dental insurance but think it's too expensive? If you answered yes to any of these questions, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company for a free information kit. See how you can help protect your teeth and your wallet by calling now 1-800-496-5920. This is real dental insurance that can help cover over 300 procedures. Everything from cleanings and fillings to crowns and dentures. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. You can see any dentist you choose, and you'll never pay a deductible. Call in the next 10 minutes, and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-496-5920. That's 1-800-496-5920. 1-800-496-5920.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about here on this live edition of Free Talk Live with King Mark the First.
And Conan.
855-450-3733. Ian is, it's his night off. He gets the sort of, we give him one night off a week, and it's a, kind of a floating night between Tuesday and Thursday. So, you know, he's not in jail today. Don't worry. 855-450-FREE. ExpressCoin.com is a great way to go about getting Bitcoins. Getting Bitcoins isn't as easy as it should be because largely regulations in the United States. But ExpressCoin makes it as fast, safe, and easy and inexpensive as it can be. So they don't require a whole bunch of information from you as long as you're below a certain threshold, which is a pretty large threshold. All you have to do is send them a check or a money order, and you can get your cryptocurrencies, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. They've got Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Dashcoin, and some others. You can do it from your smartphone. They've got an app that you can download. You just if you use coupon code FTL when you get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice, you'll get no fee at all. So it's ExpressCoin.com. They've got a very low fee for purchases above $40, and it's probably the lowest you're going to be able to find anywhere on Bitcoins. But don't say you can't get Bitcoins, because ExpressCoin makes it very easy. And now it's a great idea to get some Bitcoins, because you can use it in conjunction with purse.freetalklive.com to save up to 25% on every order from Amazon. I'm going to tell you a bit more about that later. 855-450-3733. So there's a young man, was a young man in Maine, who sadly won the Darwin Award on July 4th. He decided to take a mortar. A mortar is a firework that sort of shoots up in the air. A mortar is what those, you know, what when you go to see the fireworks the town puts off, all those big exploding fireworks, those are mortars. Now, they sell smaller versions. He probably got his mortars in New Hampshire, is my guess, because they sell them here. But maybe they sold them in in Maine. I don't know the answer to that. So he got a mortar. He decided, you know what? I'll play mortar unicorn. And he put it on his head, and boom, it killed him instantly. Now, mind you, being killed instantly is not a terrible way to go. You know, laying in bed for years with cancer, that sounds awful. But he's 22 years old, and that makes it tragic. He's got a family, no doubt about it. And what, 12 people died this year from fireworks in the United States?
Last year
in the United States from fireworks.
They're still tallying up this year.
Yeah, you're talking about one every four states. We're not talking about an epidemic sweeping the country. Yeah, it irritates upsets some dogs and some veterans, I'm sure. Probably the veterans are overblown by the old crotchety people, but that's fine. If you live in a community that doesn't have fireworks, then I hope that's one of the reasons you picked it. But in communities that do have them, it sounded like World War One out where I live, and I like it just fine. The dog, she's not so happy, but
it's not so much the noise that bothers me; it's the money. I mean, how much did you spend on your 12 mortars?
12 mortars for $50.
Yeah, I mean, and these cities, I don't know what Keene did this year. I don't know if they did anything, but these, I mean, upwards of $100,000 on a city the size of Keene on fireworks that they blow off in a couple of hours, and it hurts me deep down inside. My frugalness comes out, and it's like, why? Why so much?
Well, $100,000 from a city standpoint is really a pittance. What they're trying to do
is a drop in the bucket, yeah.
Yeah, compared to what the schools cost and things like that. That's a few kids going to school a year.
The swamp bats here are the ones that do with the fireworks, so that is the school, I guess. That's probably part of their budget, which is just even more silliness.
No doubt about it. I don't know. I don't think that the government should be buying you your fireworks. If you want to watch fireworks, you should pay for them yourself.
Mm-hmm.
But let's go to Ryan, who's calling in from Milwaukee. Ryan, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, how's it going?
All's well.
I was just wondering, since it's an Open Lines program, if you had any thoughts about the great Art Bell, who I consider to be kind of the father of Open Lines radio, returning this month.
Oh, I didn't even know.
Yeah, he was on Sirius briefly, and they had kind of a spat, and he had signed a two-year
contract. He seems to have a spat he must be hard to work with.
What it was that Sirius wasn't, their streaming service was bad. People were complaining, and the caller base was dropped. I think a lot of people that listen
to needs that caller base.
Older anyway.
He needs that. Exactly. Yeah, he needs that for the show he runs.
So now at the two-year non-compete is up on July 20th, and he's decided to do an internet free stream, I think, on his website and TuneIn, and he's back again.
So he's going to be on, do you have any idea which syndicate is carrying him?
If any.
There are, it's going to be through his website, and TuneIn is my understanding, but then there are terrestrial radio stations also picking it up before the show is even broadcast, which I've never even heard of before, but
no, that makes sense.
Yeah, isn't it how Free Talk Live works?
They're just signing up. That's all. Generally, every affiliate's going to sign up before they carry the show. On Free Talk Live, we actually allow stations to carry us before they sign a contract. But we have the easiest contract in the business. For better or for worse, that's the case.
Right.
So, it sounds great. I think Art Bell is, I think he's does incredible work, and he really created a genre, this sort of genre of, I call it conspiracy, weird radio out there.
right, yeah.
He was just doing a regular talk show. I actually heard him speak at a Radio and Records situation. He said he was just doing a regular talk show at one point, and he just got sick of it, talking about the lying politicians and the issues of the day and blah, blah, blah. And he decided, that he wanted to talk about, some ghosts and some aliens and, apparently Nephilim and a variety of other things. And, it's compelling, interesting radio. I one time heard one. It wasn't an Art Bell show, mind you. I've heard many of his. I think it was Ian something that was doing it at one point for him, where a guy who is self-identified as a horse, and, you know, this guy believed that he was a horse in a man's body. And he had this shtick nailed down, right? Like, it was just so awesome to listen to this guy talk about how he was really a horse. And
yeah, that's really the thing, is that I'm a skeptic. I don't even believe in ghosts. I don't think aliens, they probably exist, but I don't think they've visited this planet. Right. But those shows are just so compelling.
Yeah.
And the nature of open, that's why I love Free Talk Live, is the, you know, anybody can call in, and you never know what you're going to get.
Yeah, I think that an Art Bell seems to have had a real knack for getting rid of terrible callers, making bad callers better, and making mediocre callers good. I really felt like he could, and that's what a talk show host is supposed to be, an open line talk show host really is supposed to do. I feel like Ian can do that. I don't think I can. But anyway, nonetheless, Ryan, thanks for the call.
Yep.
855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live. Tell me your favorite thing about radio.
Want to listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programs without a radio signal or internet? Just call 605-562-4213. Get instant access to all GCN live feeds right on your phone, anywhere you want, anytime you want. 605-562-4213. It's our way of ensuring everyone has the opportunity to enjoy GCN. 605-562-4213. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
It's the video sensation that's taking the internet by storm. A web series on YouTube passed the 100 views mark this week. Titled Andrew and John, the wildly popular webisodes feature roommates Andrew Vanier and John Haney playing fictionalized versions of themselves in unusual situations, mostly set in and around their Chicago apartment.
Dude, did you get my tart?
What's a tart?
Oh, you just texted me a fart.
Their latest short titled Laundry Day reached the unprecedented 100 view milestone this week after a heavy promotional push in which the duo posted the skits to their Facebook pages. The hit video features the roommates wearing unconventional outfits while scrounging up enough change to do laundry in their basement. Other popular episodes include Foreign Landlord featuring John's friend Brett from work and a video where Andrew suspects John might be a zombie.
Our videos consistently get over 50 views now, but Laundry Day, that's the first one that's really taken off.
Yeah, everyone I know has seen it.
It's completely viral.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. You can take over the airwaves and give us a call. Talk about whatever it is you want to talk about. 855-450-FREE. It's King Mark the First.
And it's Conan the Libertarian.
Conan, we're talking about a story of a Maine man, as in a man from Maine, who sadly won the Dumbest Guy in Maine award on July 4th.
He got the Darwin Award for sure.
Yep. And go on with the story, because there's a reason we're reading it.
Right, so he definitely left some people behind, including his fiancée, Kara Haley,
yep.
Said the whole thing was an accident.
Yeah,
Haley,
sure.
30, oh, he was dating an older girl, too. He was really had it going on.
Mm-hmm.
30 says Staples was likely buzzed from alcohol and that he accidentally lit the cigarette lighter in his hand.
I never used the term buzzed. In my opinion, you were either drunk or you're not.
Especially a young 22-year-old. You're drinking for a reason, and it's not to get a buzz.
Right, and I get that people use the term buzzed in order to describe the level of drunkenness that they're experiencing. However, I don't believe anybody who uses the term is qualified to decide whether or not they are in fact drunk or buzzed.
Because I use the term. I have to, determine what level I was at.
Right. I get that when I say, I was drunk last night could mean 2 glasses of wine or 10 glasses of wine. And so therefore, there's probably a better use for it. I'm always skeptical of anybody who uses the term buzzed, if you know what I mean.
Well, I use it. And when I'm buzzed, I've just got a little mellow warmness and, I can still have a conversation without slurring.
I had a friend who slurred after a half a beer. It was just like, poor guy, he couldn't help himself. He just always sounded drunk.
They're out there.
Whenever he drank. Actually, I believe he just stopped at some point because it's got to be embarrassing. You can't drink if you slur your words.
Right. And some people can't open up and even talk to people, however, unless they, get a little in them.
Yep, yep.
Get that little buzz going.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a definite thing. And it's too bad that, some people can enjoy a nice alcoholic beverage while others can't. And people who don't like alcohol for whatever reason, can't indulge in, other things. That might, lift their spirits a little bit, help them socially.
Yeah, I don't know. I would not venture a guess to say whether or not this guy, if he had been smoking marijuana, would have made the same decision. But
he probably would have still been sitting on the couch on the porch, watching the fireworks.
A lot of bad decisions on alcohol.
Yeah, they do for sure. So, anyways, he left his fiance of 30 behind. She says he was probably buzzed when he lit the cigarette lighter in his hand while dancing with the fireworks on his head, the Portland Press Herald reported. He would never intentionally do something like that. He was just trying to get us to laugh, Holly said, the Press Herald. Friends of Staples who were with him at the time said they tried to dissuade him from the stunt and were taken aback when they saw the fuse was lit. Haley told the Press Herald that after she saw the mortar was lit, she yelled at Staples to throw it away, but it was too late.
Man, those wicks on those mortars go fast.
Mm-hmm.
They are, it's not something to play around with. And I mean, a lot of what they're saying here is he just had the mortar on his head and was dancing around with a cigarette lighter, flicking it, and it accidentally got lit. Really? Is that the story I'm supposed to believe? I'm not buying it at all.
And
it sounds like he was going to, because I mean, I can see having lit off these mortars, I can see how one might think that you could light it off of, you know, set it on your head and light it off. Mm-hmm. It doesn't look like it would kill you at all.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened here. I don't know if the thing misfired or whatever. But I'm pretty sure the instructions, if they don't say don't put it on your head, yeah, they should, I guess. No, they shouldn't say that. What they should say, you just shouldn't put fireworks in your heads, kid.
Exactly. And I think that's what's really happening here is his friends, his fiance, his mother, they're really trying to save him from the Darwin Award.
Yeah.
They just don't want him to go out like that because no one wants to go. I mean,
right. They don't want him on the internet listed as, you know, hey, forevermore, this guy won the Darwin Award for 2015.
Right. Kathleen Staples, Devon's mother.
And I believe that this is an actual award handed out by people. And you got to consider every one of these people had a mommy and a daddy, and they cared about them.
Right.
It's sad, but look, maybe, you know, let's let this tragedy be instructive as possible. Rather than vigilantly protecting the memory of your loved one, let's let their death be as instructive as possible for other people's loved ones, and maybe their 22-year-old drunk kid won't do this.
Right, and his mother is actually trying to do that, but she's trying to use the power of law to do that. We could have something like the Darwin Awards, and I'm going to have to look this up in a second because I want to see, you know, who the winners have been in past years. But yeah, that should be the way to handle these types of idiocies is to proclaim them on the YouTubes and on social media and on the news, even if it's mainstream, you know, letting people know that, yeah, some idiot out there put a fireworks on a mortar on his head and it killed him. So, I mean, this is something you probably shouldn't do. Some guy jumped into a gator pit after he says, F you, gator, and he didn't last very long.
Yeah.
We need to know about these stories. Otherwise, you know, my kid might try to do something stupid like this, and next thing you know, I'm trying to get my kid off the Darwin Award list.
Yeah, I got Darwin Award here for 2014. Was the mummified remains of a man discovered in Tucson manhole. Tell their own. Anyway, I'll tell the story after we're done.
Okay, so anyways, Devon's mother said her son wouldn't have ever lit a firework if he had thought it was actually going to go off. Yeah, I don't think anyone would. Well, I don't know. I think he was actually trying to fire it off his head like a unicorn.
I've seen people hold firecrackers in their hand and light them.
Right, I've seen them put them up against their groins, doing, yeah, are having firework wars out in the streets where they're shooting each other. You know, it's, yeah, this happens all the time.
I had a friend who held one closed in his fist, and he really wished he hadn't done that.
Wow.
Because, I mean, it just concussively blew his hand open. It didn't, from what I know, harm him, but, yeah, I mean, you know, that's just a firecracker. And I've seen people do stupid things with M80s, too.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So his mother says, that would have been suicide. I can't see a happy boy wanting to destroy himself. She said,
he was trying to make people laugh. He was cutting up.
He believed it was a dud. He stuck it over his head and he was just goofing off. However, Maine Fire Marshal Joe Thomas said the mortar had been fired earlier and that he can't imagine someone would have anticipated that it was a dud. The Associated Press reported, Thomas reported the investigation into Staples' death determined it was an accident. Friends and family.
It's an accident.
Yeah, exactly. Friends and family members, friends and family members
of Staples.
As missing an of.
Oh, there you go. Well, this is the problem with a lot of these news stories, by the way, are written by computers. So.
Oh, are they really?
They are.
That's an article I want to read next.
Yeah.
Always looking to entertain. Hallie says Staples, a proven dog lover. I don't know what that has to do with anything.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just trying to humanize him. Mm-hmm. And I think this is a very human act. I've been a 22-year-old male, and I will tell you that they aren't the smartest creatures on God's green earth.
Yeah, they have to learn hard lessons.
That's what we call experience. Some people, sadly, don't make it through experience in order to become wise. And frankly, I think wisdom is overrated anyway. I mean, people make mistakes all the way up till their oldest years. So, you know,
just look at old people voting records or old people just voting in general.
Well, what's the Churchill quote? The best argument against democracy is spending 5 minutes talking to the average voter.
Yeah. And they are the more than average voter. The older folks are the ones that do all the voting.
They do a lot of that, yeah.
Well, they get a lot of the stuff too. Let's see, where was I? He's a dog lover. He was intending to become a veterinary technician. Mm. intended to start classes at Washington County Community College this fall. Stables at one time lived in Orlando. He's from Florida, probably. There's your problem right there. He worked at Disney World, dressing up as a character like Gadsden from Beauty and the Beast.
Being from Florida, that means completely meaningless to me. It's like, I figure that for whatever reason, Florida gets more news than most. I don't know exactly why this is. But
it's the heat.
I don't believe Florida people are any more stupid than the rest of the world. But man, oh man, the weirdest stories do come out of that state.
They do.
I don't know. Do you believe that people from Florida are somehow a bit more dumb than the rest of America? Give us a call at 855-450-3733. It's 855-453 on Free Talk Live or LRN.FM.
You, Me, and BTC is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
We're sitting down with Mr. Jason King. If you want to with the government, feed homeless people, man.
Jeffrey Tucker.
What's possible in the Bitcoin space? It sounds a little like science fiction, but if you wait enough time, it becomes a reality.
Angela Keaton from antiwar.com.
This is what the United States does. It involves killer robots. For Bitcoiners, this is a way to get around that.
Subscribe at youmeandbtc.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Now, a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price, $89.95. But now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.FM? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.FM. That's LRN.FM.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Reading a story here about a guy who's competing for the Darwin Award 2015. Telephone number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That is toll free, in case you've wondered. Seems like everybody's got free long distance these days. 855-450-FREE. But if you're you can use the Skype app on your smartphone, or call us on your home computer setup using Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. If you've got to send us a user request, but that takes maybe 5 minutes for me to approve or whatever, and then you can sound better. It's really a better quality.
It does.
Yep. So username LRN, that says in Liberty Radio Network, .fm, and you can go there and listen to all kinds of Liberty-oriented programs. But the username on Skype is what you use to give us a call. 855-450-FREE. So the mother of this young man, Devin, what was his name?
Devin Staples.
Devin Staples. Doesn't want his name tarnished, and, she's looking to have stricter laws in Maine. Maine recently, 2012, relaxed its fireworks laws to maybe perhaps compete with its neighboring state of New Hampshire.
Live free or die.
Yeah, it's got to be tough being next door to the live free or die state.
That's right.
Freest state in the union. So there's a certain level of competition. Now you can fire fireworks off your head and die. And Devin Staples did. Now, I'm not making fun of this guy, but I think that it's important to talk about this because, well, all the laws in the world, fireworks, when I was playing with them as a kid, were illegal.
Correct.
We buy them in South Carolina back in the day, and I don't know what the rules are now in South Carolina, but back in the day, that's where you got cigarettes and bottle rockets. And so I didn't buy cigarettes, but I was sure interested in bottle rockets.
So you're saying laws don't mean nothing.
Right. I had these things, and I did dumb stuff with them. Not as dumb as this, but yeah, I mean, I did sort of silly things. Once you've let off a few fireworks, you're like, let's try something new.
Mm-hmm.
And so I had built a PVC pipe gun for bottle rockets, and I would thread the wick through and sort of light them off like a musket. And it worked really well, and frankly wasn't that it did not appear. I never had a problem. I guess I don't want to give any advice as to how dangerous it was. I didn't have a problem. If for whatever reason a wick, a wick sort of burnt and it didn't go the right way, I'd drop the thing and run away because I didn't want exploding in my hand. I knew what was up. But there's still accidents that happen with fireworks. Everybody who plays with fireworks is taking a risk. 12 people a year die from fireworks, which is about a quarter of the amount of people that die from cows.
Yeah, I'm wondering how many people die at the firing range, firing their rifles, handguns, whatever.
I don't know, but I remember there being a story of a young person in like Arizona or something firing an automatic weapon at a range that allowed this, and it killed the instructor.
Wow.
And then there's been other circumstances where the young person killed themselves. So like they just can't hold the, when they haven't had a lot of practice, it's just like it just jumps out of their hands, you know?
I've seen that. So anyways,
yeah, dangerous.
This kid's mother, in the wake of her son's death, Staples, her mother is also advocating for more strict fireworks regulations in Maine, because this is what happens every time. Anytime some kid dies in a wreck or they shoots themselves at the firing range, like the kid you're talking about, or in this case, the fireworks, the moms and the regulators and the legislators come out and they got to do something to help keep Darwin at bay. And that's by creating laws for example, abolishing the law that was in, whatever the law is in, that was that came about in 2012 that allowed this firework to enter into the state.
Yeah.
So the state just recently legalized fireworks in 2012 after a ban of more than 60 years. Staples told the AP on Monday that regulations should be similar to those for firearms or driving cars.
Well, that's interesting. So if the claim is that a person should be 16 or 18 years old to use fireworks, that wouldn't have saved this guy.
Wouldn't have saved this guy. He was 22.
Now, is there a license? Is that what they're proposing here?
I think she's talking about some kind of instruction where people get better instructed on the ways of fireworks.
In order to fire fireworks, you need to take to get a fireworks and you know, user license.
Probably a permit. You got to have in order to get that, you have to be licensed. Yeah. So you have to go to some training course on Saturdays at the police station out in their vacant parking lot.
If they give a permit out, they give a burn permit. I wonder how many people are killed just by their own fires that they set for burning leaves and stuff like that every year. But they give out burn permits in my town. Just some guy comes by, looks at your pile and says, okay, and writes you a piece of paper and says it's fine.
They don't even do that here. I just call them up every time. I'm like, hey, I'm having a fire.
Okay, well, I wouldn't propose to know what the law is, but I'm careful when it comes. I'm on the fire department. Mm-hmm. If there's a problem at my house, I'm going to look really bad.
Oh, yeah, and not to mention, if you were to, say, have a fire without getting the said permit or permission.
Yep.
And you did burn your house down, guess who's probably not going to get covered under home insurance?
Yeah, that's probably true.
These guys aren't stupid. They're looking for ways out of what they owe. And if you burnt your house down because you're an idiot, you're probably not going to get covered unless you have special EDC coverage that you sign on to.
Yeah, well, it's pretty relatively easy to soak the ground around a fire, and that really can be quite helpful.
Yeah. I got the fire ring, I got the fire, the water hose, the whole nine, and I have fires as often as possible. I just really like going out there and getting back to my inner caveman. It's good, good stuff.
Well, your name is Conan.
Oh yeah. So anyways, at least it had been a little bit more than, here you go, she said, that's an explosive. So she's talking about special instruction. And other because otherwise you can just go to the clerk and say I want to buy that on that shelf behind you, and that's it.
That's what I did in New Hampshire, and I've survived the experience so far.
And these things are very colorful, and there's hardly anything on them. There's a lot of warning stickers, but it doesn't say how to actually use it all of the time.
I feel bad for this woman. She's lost her son. It's the most valuable. I hate to call it thing, but that's how I feel. When I think of my child, I think of him as the most valuable thing I have ever possessed in the world. And possessed and thing aren't the right terms for the experience, but I hope that it portrays to people that this is more important to me than anything else. Yeah. So I get this is a tremendous loss for this woman. But statistically, 12 people a year die from fireworks. This isn't an epidemic, and there's no reason for the rest of us who are conscientious fireworks users to have to go through every step in the book because something bad happened to Devin.
Yeah, especially when we just got our Maine, in this case, just got their freedom, their fireworks freedoms back after a 60-year lull.
Yep. But this is the kind of emotional appeal that results in these laws. I mean, this is how you get a legislator. Look, here's my son. He's a good-looking young man, isn't he? You see the picture of him. He's a good-looking kid. And by the way,
I also found, so when he was in Orlando working at Disney World, he played Gaston from Beauty and the Beast, who was this big hulking idiot. So that makes sense, because I was seeing memes of this guy already popping up, and it had him as Gaston. I'm like, what does that mean? Well, now it makes perfect sense.
I know nothing of Beauty and the Beast, so
he's a big dummy.
Okay, well,
it's fitting.
Yeah.
So anyways, so you said that legislators are going to get involved. So Maine Representative Michael LaJoie told the AP he's considering trying to introduce a measure to restrict the use of fireworks, though he wonders if it will increase safety. They're going to say, well, you can't regulate stupidity. And it's true, you can't. But the fact of the matter is, if you have to try, you have to try something. And he is not giving up. So, and there were 11 firework-related deaths in the United States last year, according to this article. So yeah. you can't fix stupid. He's absolutely right, but he has to do something. And I mean,
no, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't.
Right. This is not the failing of the Maine legislature that Devin Staples died. I'm sorry that it happened. I do not celebrate his death. I use it as a foil from which to educate people around the United States and around the world that fireworks are dangerous and you shouldn't do silly things, that you should follow the instructions. And even when you follow the instructions, now and then, something's still going to go wrong.
Mm-hmm.
That's the chance you take with fireworks. I do think a fireworks manufacturer that if something goes wrong and you follow the instructions, you probably should have video. And
another good reason to videotape everything.
Yeah, you can prove that, hey, look, I was doing as the instructions stated, that fireworks manufacturer should be responsible for whatever
injuries. That makes good sense right there.
Right. That is as far as I'm willing to go. It's not a regulation. That's just a tort, really. Honestly, any other manufacturer of any other thing should be responsible if things don't operate as they're supposed to. What do you think? 855-450-3733. 855-450-FREE. When it comes to fireworks, you take your chances. Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, freshening of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded
or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, July 7th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.62 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $270. Antiwar.com reports at least 12 people were killed and 25 others wounded yesterday when an Iraqi Sukhoi Su-25 warplane accidentally bombed the capital city of Baghdad, dropping its munitions into a residential neighborhood. All of the slain were reportedly civilians. Iraq, which had virtually no air force when the Islamic State war began, bought the Su-24 and Su-25 warplanes from Russia last year. Iraqi officials are blaming yesterday's bombing on a technical failure that led the plane to drop a bomb over the new Baghdad neighborhood, destroying several homes. Officials are trying to downplay the incident, but this is likely to add to concerns among Iraqis that the government doesn't seem to have a handle on the Islamic State war and that the military is simply incompetent whenever it tries to conduct operations. Iraqi officials say the warplane was in the process of conducting a bombing run when the technical failure occurred, which is puzzling because New Baghdad is on the eastern side of the city, comparatively far from any of the Islamic State neighborhood. The closest the Islamic State forces are west of the city along the Anbar province border. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports former Attorney General Eric Holder will return to work for Covington and Burling Law Firm, where he was a partner for 8 years. Holder was the head of the Department of Justice from 2009 until 2015 and was the third longest serving Attorney General in U.S. history. According to Covington and Burling, where Holder was a partner from 2001 to 2009, Holder will focus on complex investigation and litigation matters, including matters that are internal in scope and raise significant regulatory enforcement issues and substantial reputational concerns. Holder was replaced by Loretta Lynch, who was sworn in on April 27th by Vice President Joe Biden after Senate Republicans stalled her nomination for 167 days over abortion language in a human trafficking bill. Timothy Hester, chairman of the firm's management committee, said in a statement, "It is a source of great pride to welcome Eric back to the firm after his distinguished service as Attorney General. Eric's entire private practice career has been as a Covington partner, and we look forward to the role he will again play as a colleague, leader, client advisor, and advocate." Holder said returning to the firm was like coming home. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports New York City has agreed to pay more than $330,000 to six Occupy Wall Street protesters who were doused with pepper spray without cause, an incident that helped galvanize the movement during its early days. Lawyer Mark Taylor, who represented three of the protesters, said on Monday that the settlements for each of the six individuals ranged from $52,500 to $60,000. Taylor said, "We think it's good compensation for the injuries that occurred to our clients. They are settlements we think reflects the city's realization that they were very much liable." The deals, which resolved several civil lawsuits filed in Manhattan federal court, come nearly 4 years after Occupy protests swept the country as activists called for greater income equality. The city did not admit wrongdoing as part of the agreements. The incident, captured on video, occurred on September 24, 2011, just a few days after Occupy protesters set up camp in a park in New York's financial district. The video shows Deputy Inspector Anthony Bologna using pepper spray on several protesters during a march in downtown Manhattan. The New York City Police Department docked Bologna 10 vacation days for violating the departmental policy. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In a statement this week, famed actor and television icon Dick Van Dyke confessed to being the Zodiac Killer, responsible for terrorizing Northern California in the late 1960s and early 1970s. The 85-year-old actor, known for his television and film appearances in classics such as Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, Mary Poppins, and The Dick Van Dyke Show, said he committed the Zodiac murders but also killed over 37 additional people. Van Dyke said, quote, "It was unbelievably easy for me to go kill someone, come back to Burbank, and get on set. It was actually part of the fun to see if I could book a flight and make it back in time." Van Dyke's confession is corroborated by several eyewitnesses describing the Zodiac Killer as, quote, "a gangly, loose-limbed man with a toothy grin and a spring in his step." In other news, the open dialogue two Americans are having about race is pretty hilarious. A husband is experimenting with an open marriage, and a f***ing loser is at a movie all by himself. This episode of The Onion Week in Review was paid for, funded, and entirely created by The Onion, and in no way benefited from cheap, thankless viewers like you. For more, keep checking TheOnion.com.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. In the last hour, we were talking about a terrible situation in Maine where a young man decided to shoot a mortar, fireworks mortar, off his head, and it killed him instantly. His mother's calling for more regulation. I guess saying that this essentially, that this isn't the lowest common denominator situation, but in fact, this is a situation where it could happen to anyone. Mm-hmm. And I do think that fireworks accidents can happen to anyone, but there's 12 deaths last year, 11 or 12 deaths last year. It's not exactly an epidemic. I don't think we need more regulations appealing to the lowest common denominator as opposed to sort of average responsible fireworks users. That's that. But what it brought up was the topic of the Darwin Awards. And I said I was going to read last year's Darwin Award. And so for 2014, the title is The Winner of the 2012 Hide-and-Seek Tournament. The mummified remains of an Arizona man were found at a Tucson manhole. They tell their own poignant story. In May, the manhole was opened to investigate a fluctuation in electrical power. According to records kept by Tucson Electric Power, the manhole had not been opened in the past 5 years, so the team that entered the underground high-voltage vault was quite surprised to find the desiccated remains of a man slumped near cut copper wires. In his shriveled hand was, can you guess?
Oh, cutters. He was stripping wire. He was collecting copper, wasn't he?
Yep, bolt cutter. Crime pays so little and costs so much. This nominee not only failed and fried, but also nobody noticed, making death both stupid and sad. An autopsy confirmed and the obvious conclusion that electrocution was likely the cause of death. The date of death was set at somewhere between 1 and 2 years. Previous to this discovery, the mummy was carrying ID for a 51-year-old man. The DNA testing is underway to verify the identity of the crispy copper cutting critter.
You know, I browsed through real quick and I saw a lot of electrocutions that made it onto the Darwin Awards. I'm wondering, yep. I mean,
Darwin Awards also seem to have a penchant for people that are stealing. You know, if somebody gets caught committing a crime and dies in the process, you know, they particularly like that for the Darwin Awards because it's easy to vilify. This is a, when you talk about somebody's, you know, untimely demise, it's a sad situation.
It is.
I'm trying to be very careful with this situation in Maine. I mean, this guy, his mother loves him, and his fiance is probably, you know, completely distraught. Hopefully, he doesn't leave any children. But you know, it's certainly possible at 22 years old. These are terrible things. But this man was killed, sorry to say, by his own poor judgment, not by fireworks. There's nothing wrong with fireworks. This was poor judgment.
Right. If it had been a fireworks malfunction, we would have already been, we wouldn't even be talking about this story.
People are killed by chainsaws and lawnmowers, and nobody proposes to get rid of those things. It's because fireworks are entertainment.
Right.
And there's this sort of puritanical attitude in the United States that entertainment is bad and not significant and these sorts of things. But you know what? Entertainment's just another way to pass your time from life, the point between insemination and death, you know, and there's nothing wrong with it. So, no.
And also the entertainment is also something that seems to get taxed first.
Oh, yeah.
Especially when it comes to the sin entertainments, the cigarettes and the beer and the hookers.
The idea is, if you can afford to entertain yourself, everybody entertains themselves.
Right.
I don't care if they're sitting at home with an Etch-a-Sketch. I mean, they're entertaining themselves. But if you can afford to entertain yourself, well, you can afford to pay these taxes. There's poor people out there that are entertaining themselves with cigarettes and beer and a variety of things. But whatever.
Right. So, yeah. And so these Darwin Awards are going everywhere. And you mentioned the shooting. The shooting range killings. So
yeah.
There was the...
Read that story.
The 9-year-old with an Uzi, Phoenix, Arizona. This happened in 2014. This is a prime example of where the Darwin Awards should go, not to the kid with the Uzi, but to the firing instructor who happened to get, he was probably in front of her when he handed an Uzi to a 9-year-old, which is just nonsense. I mean, I started, and you as well, with a BB gun. And then we worked our ways up. A pellet gun was next, and then
yep.
there was some smaller caliber weapons, and before, you know, 10 or 12, I finally got to the 357, but there was a lot of in-between.
10 or 12, you fired a 357?
Oh, yeah, I had two instructors,
yep.
Dad and Buddy,
yep.
Who were well proficient in the art.
I can't remember what my age was when I got my BB gun, but it was relatively common for kids to get at that age. Another friend got basically a very similar BB gun, the Crossman 880 and the Crossman 881. Mm-hmm. I had the 880. He had the 881. I'm still an iron sights man because of it. That darn scope you get your head just right. this was the time that kids got them. But I imagine that's significant. I'll bet you it's like 8 or 9 years old was how old I was when I got a BB gun and let go with it. I had a certain period of time with training, and then off I go.
Yeah. Well, I got my 22 when I was about 8. And it was a huge step. I actually got it from my granddad, and it was, you know, one of my uncles. By the way, I still have it. It's a wonderful 22 long rifle with the original scope still on it. So, I mean, it's and I'm not a big gun guy either.
Well, 22 is a wonderful thing because you can practice with it. It's great for putting holes in paper and putting holes in varmints. You can eat the things that you kill with it. It's an all-around fine rifle. I think that, you know, that I like them.
Yeah, it's done everything that I've ever wanted to do. The hardest thing I ever had to get over was the fact that I am left-eye dominant, but I'm right-handed.
Oh, yeah.
So I had to train myself to close the wrong eye in my brain in order to fire correctly. Otherwise, I'd be closing my right eye. And naturally, and the sights will be off.
I'm a felon, so I can't own or use a firearm. 22s are what I miss more than anything because they're fun.
Yeah, it's a good weapon. So
tell the story.
So anyways, Phoenix, Arizona, a shooting instructor is dead, the victim of a gun range accident. A 9-year-old girl is surely traumatized, and plenty of people, including many gun enthusiasts, are asking, why give a child a submachine gun to shoot? By the way, this is CNN, and they're using all the right words to make this, blowing this out of proportion. But, I mean, they're making, as long as they make the Darwin point at the end, I'm not mad at them that much. But the deadly incident occurred Monday morning at a gun range in Arizona that caters to Las Vegas tourists, many of whom drive an hour from the gambling center to fire high-powered weapons.
Yeah, they have this in Vegas. They have... They advertise, you know, come fire our machine guns.
Spend your money at night. Come fire a machine, or come eat your buffet in the morning, and then come for lunch to the firing range.
Yeah, I see nothing particularly wrong with it. I mean, you know, if you're gonna spend $100, or I don't know how much it costs to fire a machine gun. I'm just coming up with numbers off the top of my head. If you spend $250 at the blackjack tables, you're liable to walk away with less than you would if you get an opportunity to get some brass casings you can take with you from the firing range. You know, and the experience of having fired a machine gun, it doesn't lure me in like it does other people. You know, just. Okay. When I go to Vegas, it's for the food and the shows. Other people go for other reasons.
Or the work, which is, aren't you going there tomorrow?
Sure, but I'm taking my wife, and we're going to have some great food, and we're going to go see some shows. There's even free shows in Vegas. Vegas is a great place for, as far as I'm concerned, a great place for sort of to take your loved one, really enjoy it. Jax Muffy is going to be taking care of him for the few days that we're gone, and so he's going to have a great time. He's going to get to go to places that he doesn't normally get to go, and his grandmother's going to spoil him.
Excellent. Charles Vaca, who is not going to be in Las Vegas when you get there, was accidentally shot in the head as he instructed the 9-year-old girl how to fire an Uzi, an Israeli-made 9mm submachine gun. As she pulled the trigger, the gun jumped out of her hand toward Vaca, who was standing beside her.
Yeah. It's a shame.
It's and he was shot, and hopefully, you know, fire instructors will use this as a lesson for future fire instructors, you know, to not do what he did.
It doesn't seem like a good idea to put an uninitiated 9-year-old behind a 9mm submachine gun. Yeah. 855-450-FREE. Tell me your young kid machine gun story. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
At 30dayfoodsupply.com, two of our top priorities are providing quality food at a reasonable price and protecting your security. When you call 800-700-2184, we will never record your phone call and never ask for your personal information, like how much food you have stored or where you keep it. We'll also never store your credit card information and email address on a computer. Your email address will never be shared or sold. We'll never limit the number of boxes you can purchase. We'll never use outside packers or use relabeled food from another company. Our meals are naturally high in fiber, carbs, and protein, and everything is packed with oxygen absorbers and Mylar pouches under our direct supervision at our plant in Oregon. Oregon Trail Foods and 30dayfoodsupply.com keep prices low by buying directly from their producers in Oregon and then passing the savings on to you. Call 800-700-2184 and purchase our 30-day 90-serving emergency food supply for only $99, and $10 ships your entire order to the lower 48. Visit our website, 30dayfoodsupply.com, or call 800-700-2184. That's 30dayfoodsupply.com at 800-700-2184.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. You can use Skype. Our username is lrn.fm, 855-450-FREE. If you're on the internet, you need to protect yourself. Your internet service provider, that's your ISP, is they're saving your surfing history. Criminals are sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets whenever they get the opportunity, especially when you're out and about. Governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet, not to mention the NSA sweeping up all your metadata and, you know, other data. ProXPN can solve all that. You just download their app for Windows, Mac, iOS, whatever you're using. They even got something for Linux. Just connect to the internet and you're protected from everything. No more prying, no more spying. They've got Android and, Apple stuff. You're fine there. One account works for all of your devices. You don't need to have separate accounts for each device. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL. Now, they're one of the big players in the world as far as VPNs. This is a virtual private network. And they make it possible for you to have some level of semblance of safety on the internet. You'll get 50% off with coupon code FTL50 if you buy an annual account. with our code. It's like $5 a month. So that's for the lifetime of the code, no matter, lifetime of the account, no matter which premium account you go with. Any account, you get a big savings with FTL 50. With the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, all servers all around the world from that you can access. So you'll look like you're coming from Singapore or wherever. You can privately torrent. You can get past regionally blocked websites. And you can get all that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy. That is priceless. It is proxpn.com/FTL. It was a lot of fun reading these Darwin Awards, but I kind of feel like we should move along and look at some other stuff here. This is a strange one, but I think it's kind of instructive on what the way government agents think. Michigan, this is coming from Detroit.CBSLocal. Oh, boy. Sorry, I just got a text from my wife. My pigs are being born.
Oh, great.
Michigan woman frisked and jailed for not renewing a dog license. A Western Michigan woman heads to court Tuesday after being arrested for failing to renew her dog's license. Becky I don't know, says she drove to the Kalamazoo County Sheriff's Office June 23rd to prove that she'd recently renewed the license for the family's 11-year-old dog, Dexter. Rare's 14-year-old daughter waited in the car. They don't say whether she's licensed or not, the daughter, as the mother was arrested, fingerprinted, and held for 3 hours. They frisked me and put me in the intake cell with all the inmates in orange jumpsuits, Rare said. I was pretty nervous. Failure to license a dog is punishable by up to 90 days in jail and a $100 fine. County Animal Control Director Steve Lawrence said his office gave the 47-year-old Cooper Township woman numerous phone and mail and in-person notices of the need to renew the license. The last was a phone warning that a warrant would be requested unless she got a license by May the 28th. A hearing in the misdemeanor case is scheduled Tuesday before the district judge, Christopher Hanke. We prefer not for this stuff to go to court, Lawrence said to the Associated Press. It's just a $10 license. For some reason, some people like to make it hard for themselves. Rare said that she had every intention of taking care of it, but the end of the school year and her job, it's just totally got put on the back burner.
And regardless of how necessary this law really is, they've got to make examples on occasion. Otherwise, everyone will not pay the $10 dog permit.
These things cannot be moneymakers. Like I think in my town, it's $6 if the dog's neutered, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, every place I've seen a dog license, they're not that much money. $10 isn't really anything to speak of.
Here in Keene, they're making about, I think they made like $2,500. No, that's how many dogs were licensed. I'm going to have to look those numbers up again.
25,000. I wouldn't doubt it was 2,500 dogs licensed in Keene.
And a portion goes to the state. A portion stays here in the city. But that's just dog permits, because they got every other kind of permit, too. They've got, putting stuff out on your in front of your building permits.
They've got all that.
They got marriage permits. They got all these things. All these things add up at the end, and it does turn out to be a lot of money.
Here's what I think. I mean, when it comes to the dog licenses, they spend a lot of time chasing people down. So half of these licenses must come from them sending a letter out to people regarding, after they get a rabies shot. So, they turn your veterinarian into a stool pigeon by saying, you got to tell us everybody gets a rabies shot for their dog.
Oh, yeah. They've got to send it 3 different places, if I'm not mistaken. They got to send one to the city. They got to send one to the state. And then you get your copy.
Somebody does the data entry, and then somebody is sending out the letter. They're handling the letters. They're handling the money. They're inserting the cash. They're doing all these things. When you start just chipping away at that $10, just the postage for sending out the letters to tell people to pay is going to be pretty.
And you've got the tag. The tag's got to cost a little bit.
Yeah, so they get that little piece of metal. I don't know what it costs them, but it's probably somewhere in the neighborhood $2-3. I don't know. And it just It doesn't seem like the towns are making any money. What's the purpose of these dog licenses?
Well, they can. State of New Hampshire has the ability. The towns, municipalities in New Hampshire have the ability to do away with these things. They don't have.
Yeah, they don't have to have them.
There's another. They can also. They could add cats to the list if they really wanted to. By the way, if you're talking about a rabies issue, and which is I think most people are fearful of, it's not stray dogs. It's rabies. And I don't know, I drive around Keene, and guess what I see walking around all over the place? Cats. I don't see dogs ever. I've seen like three stray dogs since I've been here, and I'm pretty sure they were, you know, their neighbor was running around the corner to grab them real quick.
The rabies is pure D bull crap.
It's crap. If you've got hunting dogs, get your dogs rabies shots. But if you live in the city, I mean, if your dogs are in the house 90% of the time, It's bull crap.
You're going to get rabies from a raccoon, you know, is what you're going to get rabies from. Yeah, I mean, it happens with a dog, but, you know, the funny thing is, they go after the people that got the rabies shot to get the dog license.
Mm-hmm.
They go after the responsible people to get them to pay, because they can't do anything about people who don't get their dog a rabies shot.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you've heard of the... my dog is dead. I'm still getting notices from the city
sure.
2 years later saying, where's our money?
I told them to take a long walk off a short pier when it came to mine. They sent me a notification that I had to get a dog's rabies shot. And I said, first off, I need you to prove that this animal is a dog. So I'm going to need a DNA test of some sort. You can come by and do that DNA test. You need to prove it's a dog. You need to prove it lives within the city limits. You need to prove that it's mine, because I've taken animals to the vet that aren't mine before.
Mm-hmm.
So the simple fact that I take an animal to the vet now makes me responsible for giving the stinking city $10.
Right.
These government bureaucrats, how do they sleep at night? They're so worthless. $10?
They're protecting you, Mark.
From what?
From yourself.
Thanks.
From the Darwin Awards.
Excellent. 855-450-FREE. Do you have a justification for dog licenses? 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Keyscore, Boundless Informant. Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state. Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betrayed their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the Off Now project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. The telephone number is 855-453. It's 855-450-3733. It's King Mark the First with you.
And Conan the Libertarian.
So, Conan, I got great news just from a text during the last segment and over the break. I'm looking at on Facebook. This is just shows you the wonders of modern technology. I'm looking at my brand new baby pigs. The first pigs born at Edgewood Farms are born to our very pregnant sow, Dirty Red. She's red. And
who is Dirty Red named after? Is that one of your senators or elect?
Dirty Red was a sibling of one of these senators, but I didn't actually own her. She belonged to the other farmer who I'm now sort of doing business with. Basically, I run a summer camp for pigs, and she takes care of them during the winter. I take care of them during the summer, and it's a great arrangement. But Red arrived pregnant, and Mother Nature has her own time, and mm-hmm. There's no hurrying her along. I knew she was pregnant, but it just seemed like it was never going to happen. So we had her separated. We built a little Edgewood farm, has a little lean-to for the pigs called Swinewood, and have her sort of sectioned off in there so that she can have her, a pregnant woman should have a little space, mm-hmm. right?
Oh yeah.
And she's getting special treats and stuff, all the apples she can eat, and we've been saving them, and the other pigs haven't been getting them, and she has just the most beautiful babies with just the most delightful markings, and I am so excited to have them born on the farm.
To eat those babies.
Well, I will.
Get in my belly, baby!
They at this point, they're just, this is the wonderful thing about being a farmer is you can get a lot of, you have a lot of time with babies, and babies are wonderful. Everybody likes babies. And then you grow them and they turn into meat or whatever. We'll probably end up selling Red's babies after they're about 6 weeks old. She's going to be tired of them at that point,
I assure you. Didn't you just pick up a whole bunch of them?
I did. I picked up five younger 6-week-old pigs today that I'm going to have for meat. But I really can't wait on – I didn't know when Red's babies were going to come, and I couldn't wait on them. You know, they're another 6 weeks behind these, and that 6 weeks is really going to matter in December when – you're trying to put you've put all the weight you're going to put on a pig, and it's time for them to go to heaven.
Right. There's a definite there's definitely science involved when it comes to raising these things.
I wish I knew it.
Well, I mean, I got the calendars out, and I weigh my because I raise rabbits.
Yep.
And the ducks and the chickens,
that's why I'm bringing it up, because you're not feeling left out right now. you are also a farmer of some sort.
Well, I mean, when I breed my rabbits, I'm marking time and date. And I know when to put a nesting box into a pen, and my rabbits are due tomorrow. And so I've put their nesting box in today, and they should be going to town right now, pulling off some fur off their bellies to make a nice little nest. Because I don't want the boxes in there. It's not only is it crowding them, but it's also they like to chew on them.
Yeah.
There's definite science when it comes to my guys.
Well, when it comes to breeding rabbits, you're much more likely for the pregnancy to take, right?
Mm-hmm.
For the sows, you put them in, you don't exactly know which ones are going to be in heat at the time. You know, they're in with the boar and the sows, they work out their arrangements.
Rabbits. They're ready to go all the time.
Hazel, my 550-pound sow, she's not breeding unless she wants to. You know, there's no. When she feels like it, that's when it's time to go. I don't care how big your boar is.
Right.
That's how that is. Hazel's a fine mama, but I'm really glad that Dirty Red, was the one who had her babies because she had just some the lovely markings on them, reds and blacks and whites. So, yeah, I got to say that having growing your own food can be very rewarding.
And it does really taste better.
Oh, it does taste better. There's no doubt about it.
There's just something about growing your own tomatoes or your hens, nesting and laying eggs.
Your eggs are tastier, your tomatoes are tastier, and your pork's tastier. I'm not much on rabbit meat. I haven't had a lot in my life. Mm-hmm. You say you rave about it. I probably should just buy some from you. And that way, we can try it at my house and we can go there, or I'll trade you some pork chops for it.
That'll work.
And so that's what we should do anyway, because I got to try your rabbit. But, I'm talking to the people out there that are thinking about it. I get a lot of interest in my pigs because I post them on Facebook. I'm semi-famous, right? Like, I got a radio show. I don't know if you'd call that famous, but there are people that know who I am. How's that?
And you're a king.
Yeah, I am the king.
People are changing their Facebook profile to Mark Edge with a crown on.
They have done that. But it's really rewarding because for a variety of reasons. You know where your food comes from, meaning that I'm sorry to tell you, but a lot of pork in this country is tortured. Those gestation cages, I just cannot brook that. I understand it means that the babies are more likely to survive. I got it. But the mama can't get up? That's just rough. Yes,
yeah.
The mamas do step on babies. It happens. I'm sorry that it happens. It's, I guess, the reason that pigs have 10, 12, 16 babies. It would be really awesome if we got $100 for every baby, and I understand why some farmers use gestation cages, but I cannot tolerate that. Also, my animals get out in the sun and dig around in the dirt. If you're eating pork from the store, it's unlikely that that ever happened. And it's sad. I mean, a pig has pig's some of the strongest digger you've ever find, and there's a reason for it.
If more people saw the way that animals were housed and actually produced everywhere in this world, not just the U.S., but mostly a lot of it is in the U.S. If people just saw, they would not be as likely to buy these products.
Because
you would see it, because it's right now it's out of sight, out of mind. You don't see how these animals are raised, and the meat tastes just fine. But if you see the close proximity and them pooping all over each other and crushing each other and the whole nine, you might not be as likely to buy an egg from the store or for some chicken meat from China or wherever it's coming from these days.
Yeah, I don't know specific. There's all kinds of meat coming from all kinds of places, but it doesn't mean that just because you buy a carton of milk that has a cute barn on it with a cow out front, does not mean that there's a cow in front of a barn that gave you that milk.
That's right.
It means nothing like that. And it's special to know where your food comes from. And there's no doubt. Grit magazine, I actually posted on my Facebook page. Grit magazine did a study of heritage breed pigs compared to store-bought commercial pigs. And I think there were nine different types of pork. The second to last, the commercial came in. Gloucester Old Spots that I raise, they were the first of the large pigs. There was one pig called a mule foot, which is relatively uncommon, that came in as a little bit tastier. But they're a smaller pig.
Is that your kosher-free pig you were talking about
the
other night?
I did talk about it on Facebook, and it turns out that that's not the case. So I don't know that much about Islam or Judaism, at least enough to ask sort of my Islam and Jewish friends on Facebook, hey, there's a pig out there that doesn't have a cloven hoof.
Uh-huh.
It's called a mule foot. And I just wanted to know, would that make it kosher or halal or whatever? So the answer to that is no. Apparently, it's not the cloven foot that's the issue. It's the chewing of the cud. So
yeah.
Actually, a mule foot, if there is such a thing, is actually less kosher than a regular pig because it neither has a cloven foot nor does it chew its cud. So they find that unacceptable.
So it's a double whammy of unacceptability.
Yeah. Halal has nothing to do with the prohibitions the Jews have, but the Quran specifically prohibits the consumption of pork. So however, there are some mullahs or whatever they are, mullahs that say that are, I guess, progressive that say, you don't have to worry about that part. I don't know how you can get away with that when, you know, you have the revelation of God there and it says no pork, no swine.
And what do these guys say about gays and the
I have no idea.
Adulterers and wearing wool on Sundays or whatever it is? Are they also lax on those?
Religion does change over time.
It does.
The problem is now we have sort of the documentation from 2,000 years ago.
That you have to brush aside.
Right. You have to say, oh, no, that with the stuff Muhammad said, forget that. And that's pretty tough when you're a Muslim and Muhammad's like the chief prophet guy.
That's right.
So, yeah. God bless his soul or whatever they say afterwards. 855-450-FREE.
Allah bless his soul.
There you go. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
What if I told you that you could have the power to heal yourself and your loved ones with the gift of music? Unlock the healing secrets of the Bible with Whole Tones, a unique CD therapy program featuring seven secret ancient healing frequencies uncovered in the music of King David. Now you can get free samples of this music to discover their power to create energy, relieve stress, break negative cycles, and restore damaged DNA. For thousands of years, music has been used to heal. Ancient Greek doctors used flutes, lyres, and zithers to aid in digestion, treat depression, and induce sleep. Native Americans have used music to treat disease. Today, music is used to soothe post-operative pain, lower blood pressure, and boost immunity. Now you can benefit from healing music therapy in the comfort of your own home or office. Visit WholeTones44.com and get a free sample of the seven secret healing frequencies discovered by King David. Visit WHOLETones44.com today for your free sample. That's WholeTones44.com. WholeTones44.com.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. We've been talking about sort of small homestead farming. What would you call it, Conan?
Well, it's a lot of people even know that I have the animals. People come over to do, they buy a piece of furniture stuff. I do a lot of Craigslisting. And then they see the ducks and the chickens and wow, they're like, oh, I'm so happy for you. And you're so cool like that. And I'm like, well, yeah, no, it's, you know, I do what I do. A lot of people don't know that I even have animals on the premises and, So they can't smell them either because I do a good job of my combination of chickens and rabbits. They do a good job of working together.
It takes management to keep the smell down. I didn't have a problem with pig odor until this year, where I got more pigs than, you know, they just kept coming.
Right, I kept asking you about this. I'm like, pigs really do smell. I mean, they were one of the sneakiest of the animals.
The pigs really smell is because they put far too many of them in far too small of an area. Right. I've got about an acre, and I've got 11 pigs on that acre, and I consider that to be too many pigs on an acre. But I'll tell you what, those pigs have more land than 90-something percent
yeah, you better believe it.
Of pigs in America. You know, I mean, they generally don't get that kind of land per pig. And I'm expanding. I got to claim brushland in order to do it. But the pigs do a great job on it. Obviously, if you're continuing to do it, you consider it rewarding. I wouldn't say for me that it's probably making any money yet. You know, I'm really not trying to turn it into a moneymaker if these pigs can't pay me what I feel like I'm worth per hour anyway. So I do it as a...
I would say the big turning point would be the slops. What are you feeding them? If you're getting free food and, you know, free bread from wherever or, you know, restaurants, you know, giving up, because people, you know, all over this country, they're just dumping the stuff out.
Yes.
And I mean, there is so many options available.
You're making
to
money
you.
On your, you're saving money on what you eat with your rabbits and chickens?
My rabbits are not making me money. It's very expensive meat. Probably $7-$8 a pound.
Okay.
So because of the feed. The chickens, on the other hand, considering that they live off of scraps, and one day I hope to fence in my whole yard and just let them run, and they could probably just live off of bugs.
They certainly will.
I'm disallowing you from having
ornamental horticulture. I'll tell you
I'm
that.
I'm getting my record was 9 eggs a couple of weeks ago from 6 chickens. In a 24-hour period.
That's pretty impressive.
It's very impressive. I can't eat that many eggs. So, I mean, and these are big monster. They're not like large eggs. I mean, or double large eggs. I mean, these are big old ostrich eggs, man. Yeah. They're very impressive.
This is the rewarding thing I'm talking about. Is you get these you get this great feeling eating your own stuff. And yeah, you know as well as I do that eggs that come from from chickens that get to chase after bugs and, you know, eat things like that are just tastier than the stuff you get in the store. You can tell.
Darker yolks, thicker eggshells.
When
you have an egg fall off your counter and it lands on the ground and it just cracks a little bit, you know you're dealing with some seriously tough chickens.
Yeah, I guess you are.
You don't have these paper thin eggs that you get from the stores.
Yeah, I mean, there's plenty of things that you can grow at home that you really can't tell the difference from the things you get at the store.
Mm-hmm.
But there are lots of things that you can grow that are totally worth it. So, for instance, strawberries. You get some good strawberries at the store, but you get some sour ones too because they're picked early. Whereas if you've got strawberry bushes,
and you got to deal with half of them being all bruised.
Yeah, that's true too.
Of course, those are the best to buy on reduced. Of course, stores don't reduce food anymore. They just throw that stuff in the garbage.
And it goes to the pigs. So this is, you were asking about this, and I think this is, for me, really the issues is if you can find food in your area, that'll really make a difference. Many stores don't throw away enough to take care of a large pig operation. So mm-hmm. you basically are, it's the smaller operations that are looking for the food. But people make money selling, feeding pigs, pig feed. So it can be done, but it really makes a difference if you can get, you know, old bread, you know, just when bread gets a little old. I get bread at my house. I'm like, man, they're throwing this away. But, you know, my wife is specific about the types of bread that she'll buy and those kind of things. And so I can't be out there eating the old donuts or anything.
Pigs are not specific.
They are not.
They love it.
And milk, it goes bad. So when you're talking about bread and milk, these things are, you know, this is what grows pigs. And so if you can get this stuff. Now, we get, my friend's also, he's an organic grocer deliverer, so he drives the truck that delivers organic groceries. Gets all kinds of organic lettuce and these sorts of things. I'm not picky. I don't believe that we should just throw away the non-organic, non-GMO foods or whatever, or GMO foods. I think that, fine, run it through a pig. And turn this food that you may, you know, otherwise, you know, think is, you know, somehow unacceptable, turn it into delicious bacon, and let's, you know, let's enjoy it, and let's have an animal that lives a good life. And then, the theory on Edgewood Farms is, you know, a great life and one bad moment. You know, they get it in the head quickly, and for me, it's very important how these animals live and how they die.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're all going to die, and it's nice to not know the moment or the hour, right? So,
do you put mortars on their head?
No, I don't do that. I wouldn't consider that to be as foolproof as I'd like it to be.
Yeah.
I have watched an inordinate amount of YouTube videos of pigs being killed. It's macabre. There's no doubt about it, but
And there's all kinds of methods. And,
yes, there are.
And I'm still developing my own system as we speak.
Yep. What's important to me is that the animal not only doesn't suffer, but doesn't look like it's suffering either, because I just don't want that on my farm. And what I found is that a well-placed 22 round that basically splits the lobes of the brain just causes them to drop like a sack of potatoes.
And they can even be eating when it happens. And so they go out.
They
do. Yeah, exactly.
If you can get it at the right angle, and you know, this guy I work with, he can get it at the right angle. He did a great job. He did my pigs last year, Rand Paul, Chuck Schumer, Harry Reid, and Mitch McConnell, and wham, 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 wham. We did four pigs in less than 2 hours.
Wow.
And that includes, you know, gutting them and the whole deal. He then takes away the guts. I don't know what he does with it particularly. But I didn't get back anything.
I need those guts for my chickens.
Right. You could have used that stuff. I'll keep it for you this year if that's what you want. But, you know, I'm sure my dog wouldn't be interested in a bunch of pig viscera, but I bet your chickens would. And these are the kind of arrangements that you can work out with local farmers. Now I have a setup with the local co-op, food co-op, the grocery store. It's basically a grocery store for hippies.
Is this Keene or does Westmoreland have one?
No, Westmoreland has no grocery stores.
they have a big old milk farm. I drove through there, by the way. And by the way, you were talking about stink. They were just, it was just wall-to-wall cows, and I smelled cow for the first time in a long time. They were strong.
I'm from the country, and I find that to be a reassuring smell.
I mean,
I take a big, deep breath when I smell like a dairy farm.
Well, I've always, because I grew up on a dairy farm, and we had, you know, 40 Holsteins,
okay.
the same cows that were at this facility.
Sure, yeah.
And so
if you have a dairy farm, why have anything but Holsteins?
But yeah, it's been a long time since I've smelled that, and I was always of the impression that if there's going to be any kind of poop that you're smelling, you want it to be cow poop, because it's just pretty much just processed grass, and it's sweet and earthy, and
they're saying,
not like pigs. Pigs are eating everything. They're eating meat. They're eating
pigs get a
sour,
lot of different
sour milk. I mean,
well, pig poop is still more valuable than pork, and cow poop at one time in the recent past was more valuable than meat for dehydrated cow manure. And this is true right now. If you can, you know, I mean, the manure is as valuable as the animal. I'm not giving mine away. I'm letting the pigs return life to my land mm-hmm. right now. And fortunately, the pigs I have aren't pooping in one particular area. Pigs often will find a potty area, and that's what they'll do. But for whatever reason, they're doing me a favor and spreading it out.
Huh.
It might have had to do with the way that I stepped back the fences this year, but it has. I guess what I'm trying to say is that I don't know if it's a big savings, but I think that it's a better life. That my son and my wife and I have a better life raising these animals that we do. In your case, the chickens are paying for themselves.
Oh yeah, you better believe it. And so I was always upset that I had to get six and I only needed three.
Okay.
So I've been complaining about that since day one, and I do get more eggs than I can eat. I have to give them or sell them away, sell the extras.
What are you getting for a dozen eggs?
I'm asking about $3.50 to $4.
Yeah, that's what I'm hearing generally is that people get $3.50 to $4 for a dozen eggs.
Or we'll just binge eat. We'll just have quiche. You know, we had like Shauna made scrambles the other day. She made 10 scrambles all in one go, and that's, you know, that was our meal.
Well, not everybody's going to have a cook like Shauna, but that some of the best protein you're going to get out of eggs, and you know,
cost effective protein.
Eat some eggs today, America. 855-450-FREE if you want to talk about your experience with small homesteading farms. 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, July 7th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.62 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $270. Antiwar.com reports at least 12 people were killed and 25 others wounded yesterday when an Iraqi Sukhoi Su-25 warplane accidentally bombed the capital city of Baghdad, dropping its munitions into a residential neighborhood. All of the slain were reportedly civilians. Iraq, which had virtually no air force when the Islamic State war began, bought the Su-24 and Su-25 warplanes from Russia last year.
Iraqi officials are blaming yesterday's bombing on a technical failure that led the plane to drop a bomb over the new Baghdad neighborhood, destroying several homes. Officials are trying to downplay the incident, but this is likely to add to concerns among Iraqis that the government doesn't seem to have a handle on the Islamic State war and that the military is simply incompetent whenever it tries to conduct operations. Iraqi officials say the warplane was in the process of conducting a bombing run when the technical failure occurred, which is puzzling because New Baghdad is on the eastern side of the city, comparatively far from any of the Islamic State neighborhood. The closest the Islamic State forces are west of the city along the Anbar province border. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports former Attorney General Eric Holder will return to work for Covington and Burling Law Firm, where he was a partner for 8 years. Holder was the head of the Department of Justice from 2009 until 2015 and was the third longest serving Attorney General in U.S. history. According to Covington and Burling, where Holder was a partner from 2001 to 2009, Holder will focus on complex investigation and litigation matters, including matters that are internal in scope and raise significant regulatory enforcement issues and substantial reputational concerns. Holder was replaced by Loretta Lynch, who was sworn in on April 27th by Vice President Joe Biden after Senate Republicans stalled her nomination for 167 days over abortion language in a human trafficking bill. Timothy Hester, chairman of the firm's management committee, said in a statement, "It is a source of great pride to welcome Eric back to the firm after his distinguished service as Attorney General. Eric's entire private practice career has been as a Covington partner, and we look forward to the role he will again play as a colleague, leader, client advisor, and advocate." Holder said returning to the firm was like coming home. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports New York City has agreed to pay more than $330,000 to 6 Occupy Wall Street protesters who were doused with pepper spray without cause, an incident that helped galvanize the movement during its early days. Lawyer Mark Taylor, who represented 3 of the protesters, said on Monday that the settlements for each of the 6 individuals ranged from $52,500 to $60,000. Taylor said, "We think it's good compensation for the injuries that occurred to our clients. They are settlements we think reflects the city's realization that they were very much liable." The deals, which resolved several civil lawsuits filed in Manhattan federal court, come nearly 4 years after Occupy protests swept the country as activists called for greater income equality. The city did not admit wrongdoing as part of the agreements. The incident, captured on video, occurred on September 24, 2011, just a few days after Occupy protesters set up camp in a park in New York's financial district. The video shows Deputy Inspector Anthony Bologna using pepper spray on several protesters during a march in downtown Manhattan. The New York City Police Department docked Bologna 10 vacation days for violating the departmental policy. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A scary day in Virginia after a mass shooting at the offices of Slash Forward Marketing. Management described the violent scene as incredibly inopportune if the company wants to hit its sales goals.
Gunshots were first heard around 9:40 a.m. VP of sales Ken Miller placed the first 911 call.
911, what's your emergency?
Hello? Someone is shooting everyone at our office. Can you guys do something about this? We really can't afford to lose focus right now.
The alleged shooter, Brian Henderson, a Slash Forward employee, was described by Miller as a so-so salesman and a, quote, candy ass who obviously couldn't howl with the big dogs. Slash Forward management said the company is rattled to the core by this poorly timed shooting.
It was horrible, really. But hashtag pray for Slash Forward is trending, and
We are getting tons of media exposure, so I think we're going to survive.
Donations for the families of victims are pouring into the company website, as are applications for the 18 job openings listed immediately after the shooting.
This is the Onion News Network.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live, or Farm Talk Live. In the last hour, it was revealed to me by my wife through text that we're having our first babies at Edgewood Farm. It's Mark Edge.
And Conan, the libertarian farmer.
That's right, King Mark the First. I feel like a king right now, having these babies born. I feel like I should rush off and be there. My wife says everything's fine. And by the way, here's a little advice for young men. Don't marry an incompetent woman.
Oh, no. You used to be taking care of her forever.
There's so many of them out there, and they need help doing everything in their lives. I'm not trying to be mean, ladies. Just saying. I'm not talking to you individually, whoever's listening to my show, lady. It's the rest of those gals that are incompetent, really.
But you know what, Mark? There are some guys who really like that crap. God. They like to take care of someone. It makes them feel like a man. And there wouldn't be as many incompetent women as there are if it wasn't for the fact that there were guys who liked to do it, that like to take care of these women.
Maybe it's
a real thing.
I don't know. The behavior must be getting incentivized in some manner or another. But I'm going to need I need a wife that can stand with me. At least that she probably does more work than I do. But if you want to feel like a man, lift heavy objects.
Take the stupid peanut butter jar top off. Or,
right.
You know.
Indeed.
Or work on the car. No one likes working on cars.
My wife, she's handling this, 450-pound sow giving birth. She's, sitting by, basically. I mean, Mother Nature takes its course. And this is extraordinarily valuable. Why would you want a life partner that isn't partnering with you? By the way, this goes for everybody, whether you're heterosexual or not. I'm just talking as a heterosexual male to, young heterosexual males, of which most young males are. I've just seen too many options of too many women out there that are like, oh, yeah, you can take care of me. I'm unconvinced that they can, you're going to have kids, and then what? How much of that am I going to take care of too?
Mm-hmm.
Not interested. Thanks so much.
Yeah.
Mark,
we agree on too many things. This is why the Mark Ian relationship works so well, because you guys disagree.
Argue. I make a living off of arguing with my business partner.
We need someone to disagree. Someone call in and tell us why they like taking care of their incompetent women. Because I know you guys are out there and you love to do it. And what do they do for you? I mean, what do they actually provide to the equation?
855-450-3733. I can tell you whatever you claim the incompetent women can do, the competent women can do better.
Yeah.
Whatever that might be that you claim. A lot of people ask me, as far as farming goes, sort of the lessons I've learned in doing it. And this is a tough one, because you learn like little ones every day as opposed to sort of big whopping ones. I would say be careful if you're intending to get into it to save money or make money.
Mm-hmm.
You really need to mind your budgets and look at the right crops and the right animals to do that.
Right. The right crops, as in you live in New Hampshire or you live in Florida or wherever. You need to grow what grows well. By the way, Florida, you can pretty much just throw whatever you want out in the backyard and it will start growing. But New England, you got to be real careful. You have to start things early, like maybe in a greenhouse.
Yeah. Yep.
To actually have it up and running so that you have enough months of actual harvest.
The advantage with New England, though, is that that there's actually a market for the local farms.
Mm-hmm.
That people will, people buy from local farms here. Most places in the United States, it's in Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine are like the first three as far as local farming purchases or whatever. So the land might be crappy, but you've got the customer base, and that's important. So if you got them
hippies over in Vermont, man, they love them homegrown tomatoes, unless they're growing their own, that is.
Interestingly, we have the people that we do business with, and we sell very little pork. We don't sell pork. We sell pigs. But the people we do business with, not hippie at all. Mm-hmm. These are just families that want to know where their food comes from. And, you know, they're libertarians and, you know, free staters and people I know. But they want to know where their food comes from, and that's fine. All they're doing for me is supplementing feed.
And now you're experimenting with the local co-op here as well?
The co-op, I'm not selling anything there. I'm taking their compost.
Oh.
So, you know, they'll cut the pieces off of celery or broccoli or whatever, and they throw it in a bucket. And then I take that bucket, and I give it back to them in 24 hours. And I just take this stuff. Some of the stuff the pigs eat, some of it they don't. I leave it in and around their trough. It, you know, deteriorates a little bit. We throw it on the compost, the stuff that they don't eat. Admittedly, my pigs are pretty well fed. And, you know, so they can be a little picky.
Yeah, we were talking about different types of pigs, and, you know, you need to get different types for different regions or different however you plan on raising them. Mm-hmm. I would be of the opinion, or I would want to have land, and I wouldn't want to have forager pigs. Pigs that weren't actually, you know, digging holes, but they were actually going out. They can actually live off the land a little bit.
Like a grazing pig?
Like a grazing pig. But
okay, so...
like a woods grazing pig.
Well, okay, yeah. I would still recommend probably the Idaho grazers.
Mm-hmm.
This is a... There's a miniature pig variety called a Cooney Cooney. Miniature is probably not the right word, but a smaller pig variety called a Cooney Cooney. And it has a very short nose, and it doesn't dig because it has a short nose. It just can't dig the way other pigs do. What they've done is they've crossed it with enough things to create this breed they're calling Idaho grazing pigs. Idaho grazing pigs go out and eat grass, and they're pretty good about they'll destroy clover, but they're pretty good about grass. And they just go out and eat. They don't dig holes. My land, when I've had pigs on it and not enough, because I'm constantly expanding. I never have enough. I'll have 10 acres and I'll be like, I don't have enough land for my pigs. But, I had a...
10 acres isn't that much for grazing animals.
Well, 10 acres for... It depends on how many pigs you have on it.
If you can smell them, you got too many.
Well, that's pretty true. But I've had pig pens that look like World War I. I mean, like, just huge craters in them and nothing living, you know, like one woody plant.
The fences are at steep angles because they're falling over because they're rubbing up against them.
They'll dig up underneath the electric fence. Pigs are...
They're very smart.
When people say pigs are smart, they ain't kidding.
Yeah, they're very smart.
I've had I had some guy who was doing some research on some scientist-y fellow on here. I'm on the Edgington Post, and I did an interview with him. The claim is that they're as smart as 3-year-old kids. I don't know what that means, but I can tell you 3-year-old kids are pretty smart. And so they're, you know, they'll throw the dirt up on the electric fence and ground it out, you know, these kind of things. The last thing you want is an escape artist pig. It's, you know, once they get above a certain size, there's nothing you can do with them.
Yeah.
Fortunately, once they get above a certain size, they're much less likely to get out too.
And they're getting closer to being on the pot anyways.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you're going to do the breeding thing, this is our first year really experimenting with this stuff. And we actually got the pig. She came pregnant. We didn't get her pregnant. That's an entirely different sounding sentence. She arrived at the farm pregnant. We didn't even necessarily know it. We thought a different pig was pregnant.
Ah.
She wasn't. So my wife's been mothering the wrong pig. But I got back from the trip to Pork Fest, and I'm like, whoa, that pig's pregnant. You know, you can look at her twiffy. You can see the nipples laying low and that sort of thing, and you can tell. And so that day I've set up everything, got her all separated because I didn't know how long it was going to be. She even seemed dilated. And so I wanted to get her separated as soon as possible. I thought it was going to happen within minutes.
Right.
And it had been, that's been more than a week ago. And then with no warning, she's expressing no milk, no nothing. Today, I just got some pigs in that I've got from a different farm. And I just checked her just before I left. And she didn't look like anything. She's popping babies out. I got a text from my wife, 8 babies.
Yeah, my rabbits will do the same thing. They won't build their nest until a couple hours before they actually birth.
It's amazing.
So they'll just sit there like nothing's going on. Hey, right as rain. And then an hour will go by, and you come by, and they'll be going to town. What they do is they pull the fur out of their bellies,
mm-hmm.
little clumps, and they build a little nest, and it's, you know, very warm and cozy. And
have you done any gardening?
I have. And it's been my goal since getting here to New Hampshire to actually do a garden, a New England garden, which I haven't started yet. But yes, big on the gardening, grew up gardening, and in I have some Tennessee gardening under my belt.
We've done a lot at my house, too. I'd love to hear your stories of gardening, animal husbandry, these kind of things. Have you had some success? 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live, 855-453.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply Safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it, and that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to simplysafedefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's simplysafedefense.com.
I just heard the best sales pitch I've heard in a long time on an airplane. The flight attendant announced, "If you paid more than $75 for your round-trip ticket, you overpaid." This is brilliant because everybody on the flight paid more, and I was struck by how all the road warriors stopped typing and reading and working and looked up. The announcement invited us to apply for the airline's credit card, and the sign-up bonus? Enough frequent flyer miles for a free round trip. Talk about turning lemons into lemonade. With some banks offering free credit cards, $75 is an outrage for an annual fee, but a bargain for airline tickets. For more tips on communicating more effectively, hit survivalspeech.com, where you can see how I got the CEO of another major airline to shower me with freebies. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You're listening to the best Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We have been talking about, just got on the jag this evening of talking about small-scale homesteading farms, I guess is probably the best way to describe it. I'm not talking about big factory operations. I'm talking about people who want to have a closer relationship to their food, perhaps save some money, know where their food comes from, you know, those kind of things. And both, and it's me, King Mark the First.
And it's Conan.
And we're both, we both do this, Conan. You've got rabbits and chickens and a small gardening operation. My wife's got a big garden, and we have an orchard that we've put in. It isn't particularly productive yet. It's still got to grow, but...
apples?
Yeah, apple, basically a bunch of different things, but we have several breeds of apples.
Yeah, they take at least 3 years before you even get anything, really.
Well, we get apples off of them, but not much.
Yeah.
And we've also got pigs at the house. I don't do the chicken thing. I know you're very successful with it. But we have a friend down the road with whom we do sort of trades and stuff like that, and she's a very large chicken operation. And
well, that's the thing, too, because if you live close enough to other people who are doing the exact same thing, or not the exact same thing, but they're doing similar things, you can go out and, hey, you know, leg a ham for eggs for a couple of months or for the season. And usually those types of trades can, you know, be beneficial to both parties. So
Oh, yeah.
You can focus on what you do best instead of spreading yourself thin and having a whole, of course, spreading yourself thin could be a good thing if you have, say, a plague where you lose part of your crops, you still have another crop that's going to survive.
Yeah.
So that could be a good thing as well.
I like the idea of having a bunch of different things. That way, you know, you've always got some stuff that's been successful. Obviously, we're not going to starve to death if the whole garden is unproductive this year. And it hasn't been. It's been quite productive.
Right. That's a big argument because as you mentioned, a lot of these things aren't actually making you money. They're actually, in some cases, more expensive than what you could buy at the store. It's not about that. It's about doing it yourself. It's about it tasting better because you did it yourself. And it's seeing the process, and you know where that food came from.
And it's, you know, whatever that brings for the child too. My son's 7 years old. He gets to see how things work. He's watching babies being born tonight.
Right.
And, you know, yeah, your kid isn't getting a biology lesson of that nature, you know, and I think that's really special.
Yeah, I'm surprised the local schools around here aren't actually bringing kids out to farms like yours to actually witness.
It's probably too dangerous.
It would be. They would step in something.
Yeah, indeed. You can't get everything by growing it at home, and the things that you do need, many of them you can get at Amazon. And you know that if you want to shop at Amazon, you can do it through shop.freetalklive.com. But I'm going to tell you how you can shop at Amazon and save 25% off. There's no other talk show out there that is attempting to save you 25% off of your purchases through Amazon. Amazon has just about everything you're going to need except like fresh meat and produce, right? Like, I suppose you can't pay your electric bill and your mortgage there, but pretty much everything else you're spending money on, you can buy it at Amazon, and now you can get it at 25% off because you're listening to Free Talk Live. That's tremendously valuable. What you do is you go to purse.freetalklive.com. Do it right now. Create an account over at purse.freetalklive.com. P-U-R-S-E. Purse.freetalklive.com. You're going to want to do this for your friends and family, too, because once you do this, you're going to see it works. And then get some Bitcoin. You can go through expresscoin.com. They actually sell it at Purse, too, but it's not a big savings once you start buying it there. So go through expresscoin.com and get yourself some Bitcoin. And then by using Bitcoin, use Purse. They've got a little instructional video there. You'll figure it out. You'll save 20 to 25% off on everything you've got. Call it a raise I've just given you for being a loyal listener. Purse.freetalklive.com. You don't even have to be a loyal listener. You just have to be listening at this moment. Purse.freetalklive.com. So, yeah, you know, what we've done at my house, Conan, is we've had the annuals and stuff, but they're a lot of work. Laura's kind of moved. I joke with her that her garden is full of berries and onions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so she grows onions and
onions, you don't have to do much at all. They just keep coming back up.
Get the Roundup out and try to stop them is what you do. I mean, they're just incredible. We don't actually use Roundup.
Yeah, whatever you do, don't put spearmint or peppermint or any of that crap in there because that's another weed.
We've got mint. So, I mean, but we have, and we have also has Jerusalem artichokes. Some people call them sun chokes.
Mm-hmm.
They're great to sort of augment a salad. So you get sort of one of them and slice it up thin and put it on top of a salad. And it's great. There's nothing like it. I mean, it's just delicious.
Wait, they are real artichokes or
they're not a variant.
They are a root.
They look like ginger. And you slice them up sort of into little circles. So when you cut ginger, it'll come up into sort of circles. But ginger, you don't use the same way. These are kind of a nutty, crisp, light taste to them. And
okay, I'm looking at them now. I know what they are. They're weed.
They are a weed, but they're an edible weed. they're great for the pigs too. So you plant them out in the pig pen, and you know let the hogs go trying to chase them down. They can't get them all. But it's nice to have food that just keeps on coming up that you can continue to eat. So we have a lot of things like this. Berry plants we have a great deal of. You know, you just kind of cycle the strawberries. You put new ones in every year, and that way you've got three beds going. They last about 3 years, strawberries do. And you can't eat all of the strawberries that come in, but you can have your friends over, and their kids can pick strawberries too.
That's right. And or you can invest in a dehydrator.
It's true.
Or you can make yourself a nice one that's with a window pane on it and out in your backyard and just mass dehydrate these bad boys.
You can freeze them too and make sort of little berry parfaits and things like that. There's no doubt about it. But what we do is that we eat fresh strawberries for the few weeks that fresh strawberries are in, and we invite friends over to. The kids fill up we give them little baskets, and they fill up their little baskets, and they get some fresh strawberries, and there's nothing like it. So this is, in many ways, creating community and giving, it gives the moms an opportunity to get together so the kids can have play dates and that kind of thing. And that's immensely valuable. You can't put a price tag on stuff like
exactly.
that. Exactly. And, we've got blackberry bushes and these kind of things. You can get them that don't have very bad prickers or anything like that, so the kids can pick the blackberries
but how are they going to learn, Mark? I grew up in the woods of Florida.
Yep.
And I would go and scope out the best thickets.
We had them all along our fence line,
and I would go barefoot too, by the way.
Do you want to put shoes on? And it means, why would you
want
to do
that?
Why
would I want to mess my church shoes up?
Right. So we had them all along our fence line. We had 10 acres out in East Bradenton, and the blackberry bushes would just grow up along there. And I'd go out with my basket, and I'd pick and pick and pick. And, yeah, I got my fingers. My fingers bled. There's no doubt about it.
And you would come back with bloody fingers, but they would be purple as well.
They would be purple as they could be. And I'd bring back enough that my mother and father could have them too. So I ate my fill. I'm sick of berries by the time I come in, but there's still enough that mommy and daddy can have plenty.
I love blackberries.
Yeah.
I love picking them.
You can't get childhood memories. You can't buy childhood memories like that. You have to earn them. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
Free Talk Live.
When a deer approaches a marijuana plant in the woods and nibbles off one of the buds, is that sad? Is that deer living a sad state of existence?
I have no idea. I've never heard of an animal eating something
but
that would
Christy,
make them,
that's because you
know,
have
alter.
No idea what you're talking about. You don't know
yes,
one
I
thing
do.
About cannabis. You don't know anything about it.
I understand that you want to partake of that drug.
Oh, I do. Trust
but
me.
Listen, I understand that you should have the right to do that.
Oh, thank you.
Where it's legal. Where it's legal.
Oh. Since the beginning of time, human beings and other animals have been altering their state of consciousness. Believe it or not, it's not just a human being thing.
Robins eat elderberries in the fall and get drunk on them.
Yes, so this is a common thing amongst the various different creatures of this earth.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855 450 free. Going to give you a break from Farm Talk Live here. It's King Mark the First with you.
And Conan.
855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about what you want tonight. Let's go straight to the phones. We've got Nathan calling in on Skype. You can do that too. Our username is lrn.fm. By two, I mean you have to wait till he's done because I really only had to run this with one. I'm not going to try to. If I try to answer, that's not going to happen. So, anyway, Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. Nathan, what's on your mind?
Greetings, King Mark the First and Conan.
Loyal subject.
Oh, yeah.
I just have to know, Conan, what is best in life?
To see your enemies driven before you and to hear the lamentations of the women. I've left one out, I think.
That's funny because I always thought the other guy who was talking about the open step with the falcons on your wrist, I thought he had the right answer to that question.
Yeah, actually, you're right. And I need to memorize that one because he was the free guy and he had the best idea. The other guy, the real Conan, he's just a bloodthirsty kind of a tyrant. And who wants to be like that? Who wants to really live like that? It's a more enjoyable life, I'll tell you.
And that is the life that you and Mark are living in the farmland of the Shire right now.
we put our green or brown thumbs. We put them out there and we try our hand at some things here and there. But we're not really farmers. We're just kind of
hobbyists.
Yes.
No, it's really interesting. Just hearing you guys talk about it because like many who've gone to public school in America, I have almost zero experience with what you might call the actual world, like, you know, seeing piglets being born and whatnot and things like that.
So. You know, I got a job at 12 years old, and I worked at a comic book store from the time I was 12 to the time I was 18. And I learned more in my after school job than I did at school. And I'm not just talking about public school. I'm talking about private school, too. A lot of the academic stuff just isn't that useful. I'm not saying kids don't need to know academics, but man, you'd think that school would teach you stuff you used.
Yeah, just learn to read, learn to count. And then after that, I mean, it's really up to what you want to do with your life.
Teach them about bank loans, for God's sake.
Teach them about, you know, making money or writing checks.
Yeah, that's what I brought up on the conversation last week when I called in about school is a lot of the financial stuff is probably the easiest to point to because it's something you use every day, but you don't necessarily get a lot of exposure to.
Of course, if you're trying to create debt slaves, the last thing you want them knowing is how to get a loan or how to finance or how to keep charge of their credit or their banking account.
Yeah, the claim is here you're making is essentially those in power don't want us to know about personal finance.
Or maybe we'll investigate their budget, their yearly budget, and we'll start to pick and sort things out that shouldn't be there, that don't make sense, and start questioning them. Last thing they want is a bunch of questioners, because that's the worst thing to, that's the worst threat to authority right there, is people questioning authority.
Yeah, and I was curious about what your thoughts were, Conan, on the schools in Keene and like why you're so interested in activism against them and that kind of thing. Because one of the things I love about your show, Black Sheep Rising, aside from your excellent taste in music and in drops,
of course, thank you, man, thank you,
is the school talk, because it's not necessarily. A lot of school talk about New Hampshire in particular, unless you go to, you know, a podcast specific to that. And I kind of like your perspective on it since you're a taxpayer, you live in Keene and so forth.
And a father.
Right. And, the question I asked last week is what I'll ask you now. Like, what do you say to someone who's sort of fully indoctrinated into the system and they think, well, public schools are educate our children and, you know, that kind of thing?
Well, I think you need to point out there are successful ideas going on in charter schools and in private schools, and they happen to produce well-educated kids that, greatly that blow away the public educated kids. There are businesses out there who are more willing to grab charter kids, or and the same thing with colleges. Colleges want your privately educated kids. But as far as what bothers me the most about it and why I talk about it as much as I do is because I am a father. I do believe that the raising of the children is the most important thing for your children. But the other thing that really bothers me more than anything is the money involved. The schools here in Keene spend twice as much as the city, and that really rubs me the wrong way because I'm a big money guy. I do all my own things. I do all my own work. I like to cut the middleman as much out as possible because I know that I can do a better job. Some people can't do that, you know. And when I can't do it, I'll hire out. But you know, the money. It's like, all about the money, and we will run out of money.
It's about the money for them too. Don't let them tell you anything different. Otherwise, they wouldn't mandate that you pay for the worst school in a given geographic area. If you go, you have to hunt really hard to find a private school or a charter school that performs worse than a public school, your regular old government school in a given geographic area. Now, I'm sure it's out there, but it's an outlier. It's an anomaly. The best schools are the ones that are funded through some level of competition. That's because the marketplace gives us better customer service when there's competition. And you just hear the government school bureaucrats cry, cry, cry. Oh, the kids won't get educated. The kids will get a better education. You damn liar.
Well, they're talking about the poor kids.
Right. Well, if it was about the poor kids, that's where the biggest lie is. If this was about the poor kids, you'd have a scholarship program to send and poor kids to schools that competed. You wouldn't have what basically amounts to a middle class welfare babysitting program. That's what government schools are, because 85% of people, I don't even know what the number, I'm just coming up with something off the top of my head, I shouldn't do that. The large majority of people send their kids to school, either they use a voucher system or they go through the government school system. This is not about educating poor people. This is about creating homogeny. This is about pandering to the lowest common denominator. This is about making sure that kids get drugs in school, the Ritalin and that sort of thing. So it's about controlling the population. It's about homogenizing thought. It's about killing off the passion that kids might have for certain areas in their lives.
Oh, that's what Common Core is right there. It's not about more efficient, better educated children. It's about creating desk monkeys that don't ask questions, that don't have creative influence, that don't want to think outside of the box. Because they will create those kids in other outlets. The officers, they'll be created elsewhere. They need desk monkeys to just push buttons, and that's what Common Core is right there in a nutshell.
Now, I don't know much about Common Core, but I can see what government schools do, and it ain't pretty. You can't create passion. You can't create intelligence, but you can stifle it.
You can stifle the hell out of it.
Yep. Nathan?
Yeah, I kind of wish that they would there would be more reporting about Louisiana, because wasn't there a big privatization effort there after like the schools were essentially bowled over by Katrina?
I remember doing an article on Shire TV like 2 years ago where, yeah, exactly, they had to start from the ground up, and I believe those were charter schools, and yeah, they were marvelous. The kids were bright, shiny, smiling, happy kids, and they only had good things to say about, what was going on. That was 2 years ago. I don't know if it's the same, because, nothing good can let, because charter schools are, they're better, but they're still, run off of taxpayers' money. And so, and there's no competition.
Well, there's some competition because depending on where you're at, there'll be other charter schools that are competing for that same voucher dollar. So it's superior, although not preferable. When you look at, I think that government schools would be better off, like, because if you were going to start from the ground up today, you would not create the system that we have.
Oh no,
it is terrible. The only people it helps are union bosses. It doesn't help teachers. It doesn't help administrators, maybe. I don't know. There's probably more administrators than there needs to be, but it doesn't help students. It doesn't help parents. It doesn't help teachers. And those are the people that you want to serve with a school. You'd start with something entirely different, and I'd love to hear some ideas on that. 855-450-3733. Thanks for the call, Nathan. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Are you
your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in. And I might be able to squeeze you in here in the final segment. It's King Mark the First.
And Conan the Libertarian.
This kind of rhymes with barbarian, mm-hmm. Right?
Oh, yeah, it works.
850.
It's better than the librarian.
That's right.
Raw! You don't know the Dewey Decimal System? Raw!
There's another one on called the Credible Hulk, who cites all of his claims. It's funny. Anyway, 855-450-3733. Conan, you've got a story about, today with the vote to take down the flag in South Carolina. Now, that isn't law yet. That's just one, I think, the Senate.
Well, this is a city. Marion County Commissioners. This just came out 4:06 p.m. It's a local news article here. Marion County Commissioners voted unanimously Tuesday to put the Confederate flag back up at the county's government complex. The flag was removed
Thursday.
Now, these
are unrelated incidents, but it's just kind of, there's a fervor around it right now.
Oh, yeah, this is big. We should have talked about this in the second hour, and this would have got all the callers that we didn't get, because people love this crap. This really is nonsense, but it really touches the heartstrings of a lot of folks out there, where the flag really is meaningful to them, and this one in particular.
Flags are meaningful symbols. People fight and die for those things. Mm-hmm. I was just watching last night Glory, which is a great movie, and everybody should see it.
Every time the flag would fall, someone would run over and pick it up and get shot, and another one would run over and pick it up.
What in the hell? You know what I want to be carrying in a situation like that?
A rifle.
Gun.
Yeah. And I'm going to be behind something.
Well, yes. Obviously that's...
Not with a big target flag that I'm holding up.
Yeah, they, the Civil War, you were just beginning to see what futile movement charges are at that point. by World War One, charges are a terrible idea. By charges, right. I mean, you know, a group of men running in a given direction. So go
After we pretty much proved to the British, who were doing the exact same thing during the American Revolution, that, hey, you don't just run up against these guys. You hide in the trees and you stand behind things. And
well, there's a variety of reasons that the United States became into being, not the least of which is that the French, whom many Americans like to make fun of, the French, if it hadn't been, this was basically, a French war with an American component.
Right. So anyways, the flag was removed Thursday and temporarily replaced with a flag with the seal of Marion County. County officials said the decision to remove the flag last week was in response to growing controversy surrounding the flag following the shooting deaths of 9 black men and women at a historic church in Charleston, South Carolina on June 17. The suspect, 21-year-old Dylan Roof, had posed with a Confederate flag and photos posted on a website that displayed a racist manifesto attributed to him. After the deadly shootings, Marion County's interim county administrator Bill Kaufman consulted with County Commissioner's Chairman Stan McClain and decided to remove the Confederate flag, which has flown outside the county's government complex for more than 2 decades. Mark, you said something last week about actually flying this flag on government premises. If you're going to have a all-powerful government and all, is this a flag that you would actually want on the premises? Does that make any sense?
It makes no sense to me. Essentially, what you're doing is you're putting, the Confederacy was a nation at war with the United States, and these organizations who are taking grants from the United States, admittedly, it's their taxpayers that are taking money from, mm-hmm. but, they're affiliated with the United States government. Now, this isn't the way it's supposed to be, but essentially, power is trickling down from Washington, D.C. to the states and to the counties and to the cities and municipalities and towns and things like that. It's not supposed to be that way. It's supposed to be from the states to Washington and then to the municipalities and stuff. And some states actually have home rule, which is an interesting thing, where the towns and cities are actually more powerful than the states. It hasn't really worked very well in practice. I'm not, speaking against it. I don't have a lot of experience.
Yeah, I can only imagine what Cheshire County here and it would be like if that were the case in New Hampshire. There are a lot of liberals in the area.
Oh, my God.
They would just take over in a heartbeat.
Thank God they can't.
Yeah.
Right? Because it would be...
No animals on the premises in the city. No burn fires.
The city gets to make the rules on the animals.
Cats would have to be licensed.
Now, the city gets to make the rules on the animals, but you can believe there'd be no guns.
Yeah.
They'd get rid of those things as quick, lickety-split, as they possibly could.
So I'm only thinking that, so why is this flag even on the premises? I'm thinking it's just to keep the old timers and the flag lovers and just keep them in their place. Because look what happens when you get rid of it.
Yeah.
You know, it's all hell broke loose.
It's to me, a great deal of fuss over nothing. Now, you're from the South?
I am from the South.
Yep. I'm from the South, too.
Born of Northerners, though.
Yeah, me too. Absolutely. But to me, the Confederate flag doesn't mean racism. I mean, when I look at the Confederate flag, that's not what it means to me.
It meant rebel.
Yeah, it meant rebel to me. It also just sort of classifies somebody as kind of country, like I'm country and I'm proud of being country. And that's fine. I got no problem with that. Obviously, I got my own farm. I get it. I'm not flying a rebel flag on it, but okay. Your country. Excellent. Good for you. I hope that all the values of a country boy goes with it, is what I'd like to see. I'd like to hear you saying ma'am an awful lot to
opening doors,
white folks and black folks.
Exactly.
And I'd like to, you conduct if you're going to claim to be a country boy, conduct yourself accordingly, sir. You have a long lineage to live up to.
Yeah.
And
they've done these studies where they've walked people down hallways, Northerners versus Southerners, and they want to see who is more likely to let the opposition pass. And they always find that the Southerners are more likely to let someone by and give them a nod, give them a wave.
I haven't seen any studies like that, but I wouldn't doubt it for a second. This was important where I came from. That was important.
Yep.
So
And they break it down where Northerners, especially city Northerners, people from the city are more likely. They have a bustling
life.
You got to fight for your space. They've got to get in there. They got to push their way through. If they're driving, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh my God, I want nothing to do with people that drive that are drivers from the big city.
Oh, I dropped someone off in Massachusetts at the airport. I'm never going back to Massachusetts again.
It's Boston specifically.
Oh my God.
It's a nightmare. It is the worst city in America to drive in.
I hate it.
I don't have any use for people that learn to drive in like New York and Chicago and things like that. Fortunately, my wife.
And by the way, you can tell too because.
Oh yeah, you can tell.
There's only a handful of them here in the area, but you can tell when someone cuts you off. First thing you're like, that's a Massachusetts plate. That's a New York plate. That's a. And usually, it is.
I can tell when I'm in the car with them. My knuckles are white. You know, I get just you know, ease up. You don't have to drive like that here, for God's sake.
Yeah, it's only 30. So
they put the flag back up.
Yeah, within minutes of Tuesday morning's vote, the Civil War era flag was seen flying once again outside the government complex as one of the five national flags, which has flown over Florida since European explorers first landed on its shores more than 500 years ago. The other four are Spanish, French, British, and the American flag.
Yeah, the Fort DeSoto near Bradenton, and we went through that, and we got to see the five flags that flew over Florida. Now that, from a historical standpoint, I'm fine with that. If you're flying the old monarchical Spanish flag and, you know, these kind of things, I get that that would, you know, that the Confederate flag should be part of that display.
Mm-hmm.
It should be on the level of those flags, and those flags should be flying under the U.S. flag. You know, those poles should be shorter. But I'm talking about government property. You should be able to flag whatever flag you want on your own personal property. And further, I'd like to call for a deep breath. Everybody take a deep breath. Because, first off, if they're taking the flag down in front of the town hall, you're not losing anything, really. Your heritage is not being disrupted here. Also, everybody who has a rebel flag up is not some kind of racist that wants to hang you from the highest tree. Really, I know. I've talked to these people. It's really just about heritage for many of them. And I mean, everybody needs to understand that flags are symbols. Symbols mean different things to people. The flags are blunt instrument symbols. They're not even precise symbols. And when you're dealing with symbols, it's difficult for people to sort of discern what you're saying. What are you saying with your rebel flag? Well, you're not saying much.
Yeah, are you really a rebel?
Well, probably not. I saw a guy today with his truck. He had a Confederate flag on one side and, the naval jack there on one side and the U.S. flag on the other. I'm not sure what he's trying to say either. It sounds like a message of
maybe he has a small you know what.
I don't know.
Trying to compensate.
I considered going.
How big was his truck?
It wasn't a very big truck. I considered going by and just doing an interview with him just to see what it was like. But I didn't have time. I was transporting pigs. 855. I'm giving the number. No, freetalklive.com. In the meantime, it's been Mark with you
and Conan. Bye.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The latest edition of Rebel Love Show is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, July 7th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.62 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $270. Antiwar.com reports at least 12 people were killed and 25 others wounded yesterday when an Iraqi Sukhoi Su-25 warplane accidentally bombed the capital city of Baghdad, dropping its munitions into a residential neighborhood. All of the slain were reportedly civilians. Iraq, which had virtually no air force when the Islamic State war began, bought the Su-24 and Su-25 warplanes from Russia last year. Iraqi officials are blaming yesterday's bombing on a technical failure that led the plane to drop a bomb over the new Baghdad neighborhood, destroying several homes. Officials are trying to downplay the incident, but this is likely to add to concerns among Iraqis that the government doesn't seem to have a handle on the Islamic State war and that the military is simply incompetent whenever it tries to conduct operations. Iraqi officials say the warplane was in the process of conducting a bombing run when the technical failure occurred, which is puzzling because New Baghdad is on the eastern side of the city, comparatively far from any of the Islamic State neighborhood. The closest the Islamic State forces are west of the city along the Anbar province border. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports former Attorney General Eric Holder will return to work for Covington and Burling Law Firm, where he was a partner for 8 years. Holder was the head of the Department of Justice from 2009 until 2015 and was the third longest serving Attorney General in U.S. history. According to Covington and Burling, where Holder was a partner from 2001 to 2009, Holder will focus on complex investigation and litigation matters, including matters that are internal in scope and raise significant regulatory enforcement issues and substantial reputational concerns. Holder was replaced by Loretta Lynch, who was sworn in on April 27th by Vice President Joe Biden after Senate Republicans stalled her nomination for 167 days over abortion language in a human trafficking bill. Timothy Hester, chairman of the firm's management committee, said in a statement, "It is a source of great pride to welcome Eric back to the firm after his distinguished service as Attorney General. Eric's entire private practice career has been as a Covington partner, and we look forward to the role he will again play as a